Today, Air Force tries to start the season off with a W as they take on the Colonials of Robert Morris University. Troy Calhoun and company attempting to continue their reign as the king of college football in Colorado. It's the Falcons and the Colonials, and it's next.
Well, Colorado doesn't get more beautiful than this. Welcome to Falcon Stadium at the foot of the Rocky Mountains on the United States Air Force Academy, where the Falcons host the Colonials of Robert Morris. Air Force undefeated at home under the watchful eye of head coach Troy Calhoun. Welcome to campus, everybody. Vic Lombardi alongside former Falcon Ted Sundquist, and nothing like coming home again, huh?
I'll tell you, a lot of emotion. Pride, pageantry, Parents Weekend, it doesn't get any better than this.
Well, you could see all of the pageantry taking place outside the stadium. In that stadium is where the Falcons have gone to work, one of only three teams in FBS over the last 3 years to win at least 10 games.
Yeah, back-to-back 10-3 seasons. Current holders of the Commander-in-Chief's Trophy, emblematic of beating Army and Navy, and a big bowl win last year over the Baylor Bears.
How does Troy do it? And by the way, how many goosebumps do you have right now?
Well, I'm telling you what, they're popping up all over me. Troy does it through consistency. He never wavers. The kids have bought into the program, and you're going to see just how much that is today.
All right, let's wrap up the tailgate. Let's get inside the stadium. Air Force football is coming up next. The Falcons against the Colonials of Robert Morris right here on Altitude Sports.
National sales event is on. Make the most of summer with a new Toyota.
We want the Great Tacoma.
Great Tacoma coming in hot.
On it.
Highlander Hybrid.
Highlander Hybrid on the double hang.
Here we go.
That red RAV4.
Run a red RAV4.
Hit the deck.
Now that's how you holler.
Right now, lease a 2023 4Runner for $489 per month. Plus, every new Toyota comes with Toyota Care, our no-cost maintenance plan.
Come in today.
Toyota. Let's go places.
Hey, it's all right, don't worry. Relax, it's okay.
Hi! How are you feeling, Mom?
Tired. Yeah. He's adjusting just like you are. But remember, we're in this together.
We love you.
Thank you so much.
The Pikes Peak Apex is a multi-day cycling and running event. Heuberger Subaru has been here since the very beginning. When we founded the event in 2020, they were right there as a founding level partner. They also understand, like us, that we've got this amazing network of trails here in the Pikes Peak region. Building more trails for more people and maintaining those trails throughout the year is really important to them as it is us. And that's really kind of in line with what we're doing with the Pikes Peak Apex. We want to get out on those trails and create adventures.
Air Force touchdown!
Air Force, winners of the Commander-in-Chief's Trophy.
Touchdown!
Bring it home!
Air Force football is brought to you by Intermountain Health, helping people live the healthiest lives possible. By your Front Range Toyota stores and the incredible 2023 Toyota Tundra. And by Ball Corporation, the future is in your hands. Recycle. Vic Lombardi, Ted Sundquist up in the booth. Let's go downstairs to the third member of our broadcast team, Katie Wingy. Katie?
Hey, fellas. Let's talk about the leader of this Air Force team, Troy Calhoun. He is in his 17th season leading this Air Force squad. And right now, he's tied for fourth in the nation when it comes to most wins by an active FBS coach at the same school. I talked with a few of his seniors, and they told me he's a motivator, he's a phenomenal role model. And Trey Taylor specifically told me that when Coach Calhoun tells him he had a good day on the field, Taylor feels like he had a great day, like one of his best days playing football ever. Taylor said hearing Calhoun's voice makes everybody more effective. And the Falcons are a lot better, guys, when Coach Calhoun's voice is heard. Look for that on the field today.
Thank you, Katie. You see Troy Calhoun there. What's amazing, Ted, is that the Air Force Falcons have had two coaches in the span of 40 years.
Yeah, and Troy Calhoun is a product of the coach prior to him, Fisher DeBerry. And he bought into the culture as a player, then later as an assistant coach, went out, learned some more football at the NFL level, and then has come back and just taken this Air Force program to new heights.
Head coach of the Robert Morris Colonials, Bernard Clark, former linebacker at the U, University of Miami. In fact, he won a pair of national titles at Miami. He's in his sixth season at RMU.
Yeah, and was just put into the Orange Bowl Hall of Fame in the 2022 class. I was really impressed with Coach Clark and the humility that he took on for last season and the plan that he's got to try to turn things around this year for Robert Morris.
Well, let's hope they have a better days ahead. He called last season abysmal. By the way, Air Force wins the coin toss. They will defer. Let's take a moment to appreciate the flyover. We got four T-38 Talons coming right at you.
Yeah, at a Shepherd Air Force Base in Texas. You gotta love that little, that plane has served the Air Force well. A lot of Air Force pilots over the years learned how to fly in the T-38.
All right, Ted Sundquist, you played here, you coached here. What are the keys for the Falcons?
Well, I'll be honest with you. We got a new offensive look. It's going to be the same. It's going to be the same offense, but new folks at various positions. Control that football. That's what they do. They wear you down, and by doing that, you can't turn the ball over. Don't give Robert Morris easy field position. And then on defense, pressure, pressure, pressure. What do I mean? Up front, at the linebacker level, and in that secondary.
Again, the Air Force Falcons will kick. They won the toss, but choose to defer here. If you're watching at home, you'll notice stadium looks a little different because the East Stands are under construction, part of the $90 million renovation here at Falcon Stadium.
Yeah, you know, it's got a different look. I mean, we can see all the way out to Kansas from the press box up here now. I mean, nothing blocking our view. That's going to be exciting.
All right, Air Force kick it off. It'll be Matthew DePore kicking off for the Falcons, and the return men, Kamano Sullivan and Day-Day Jones. Here's the opening kick of the 2023 season right through the end zone, and Robert Morris will get its first go at it. Robert Morris, a completely different team, much like Dion up in Boulder. Coach Clark went to the transfer portal to upgrade his football team.
He did. Somewhere between 30 and 40 players are brand new to the Colonials, and we're going to see a team that's not anywhere close to what they finished the season with last season.
Including a brand new quarterback, Tyler Zielkowski, who's a transfer from Albany. There's only four career passes before making the move down to Robert Morris. Kamana Sullivan in the backfield with him. Here we go, first series for Robert Morris, 0-11 last season. And this is a run play that goes for about two. Our players to watch brought to you by King Supers, fresh for everyone. For Robert Morris, Tyler Zielkowski obviously makes that list. Their running back, Kamano Sullivan, played last year. And on the offensive line, one of the anchors, Noah Steverson. This sets up a second down now, a second and eight. Day-Day Jones in the backfield with Zielkowski. Fake the handoff. Zielkowski will take it himself. He'll slide short of the first down. He's not known as a running quarterback, Ted, but if he has to put it on the ground, he will. Kapono Blake comes up to make this tackle.
Yeah, Air Force defense is going to try to force Zielkowski into running that football. And good job by that secondary right there. Nobody to dump it off to. Third down now and a little over six.
Third and six for a Falcons defense that only allowed 254 yards a game last season, among the best in college football. In fact, the best. Here's a swing pass, and that one is through the arms of Kamon O'Sullivan. Did that go backwards, Ted?
Looks like it did. Air Force has jumped on the ball, first turnover of the game.
Wow, so that pass actually went backwards, which constitutes a lateral, and if that's the case, that's a fumble in Air Force football. Jamari Bellamy with the recovery. Got to get a replay of this.
Yeah, you really have to. Colonial's trying to dump that ball off out in the flat, just giving some room to run. Here's the replay.
Might have to bring a level out here to see exactly where it crossed. There's the pass. The outside hand of O'Sullivan, and they're going to call that a fumble.
Well, I tell you what, I think you have to. That ball's going backwards.
All right, starting at quarterback for your Air Force Falcons, Zach Larrier. This guy can burn. Behind him, John Lee Eldridge and Owen Burke. Handoff up the middle to Burke. He'll churn for a couple. Tackle made there by Garrett Fairman, the senior, fifth year for Robert Morris.
Well, that's the first time in the last 3 years that we haven't heard Zeke Daniels and Brad Roberts with the handoff there. Larrier to Burke.
Not easy to replace the duo of Brad Roberts and Zeke Daniels, but it's on to a new generation here in Air Force, and Larrier's going to run this one left. He'll get the first down, and that'll move the chains. It looks like he gets the first. Larrier, by the way, do not give him open field. This guy's a two-time 200-meter champion in the Mountain West, also a 400-meter champion. He can go.
He might be one of the fastest.
Personal foul, illegal block right below the waist. Number 10, defense. That penalty enforced half the distance to the goal from the end of the run. Automatic first down.
All right, explain this one to me, Ted. We know you can't cut block anymore, college ball.
Well, from a defensive standpoint, I look right here. They're trying to come up and force right there to the bounce outside. You can't go low on the blocker on the defensive side.
That's Britton Pascoe. What do you expect the poor guy to do? Take him head on? Option right. John Lee Eldridge to the 5-yard line. That's really going to make it tough on these DBs, isn't it?
Yeah, it really is.
You've got a big old fullback coming at you.
You've got to take them up top. That's exactly right. And most of the time, you're going to use your body to try to influence that lead blocker one way or the other. You want the ball carrier to have to bounce outside farther and then let your pursuit come up and make the tackle.
All right, Eldridge will take a seat. Owen Burke positioned behind Zach Larrier. First and goal for the Falcons. Second and six, I should say. Larrier going to hand it off to Burke, and there is nowhere to go. He is consumed at the line of scrimmage.
Good job by that Colonial defensive front right there, creating penetration.
Good ensemble of tacklers there for the Colonials, led by a fine group of linebackers. In fact, their forte is that linebacking core. They got a lot of talent back there.
Yeah, they really do. The linebacker right there scrapes off the defensive tackle to make the play.
Movement down the line of scrimmage, and this is why you have season openers, because Coach Calhoun told us you have so many new faces on that offense. You're missing five of your top six playmakers this season. Sometimes the discipline of an offense
offside
takes time.
That's exactly right.
Defense with contact.
But it goes the other way. It goes the other way. That is on the Robert Morris defense as Bernardine Florima made contact at the line of scrimmage. And this will set up about 3 yards to that end zone for the Falcons.
Well, one of the things the Air Force offense has done for years is use cadence and movement to try to get the defense to jump. And right there, they were able to do that, get a free down.
Third and goal now. John Lee Eldridge and Cade Harris in the backfield with Larrier. They're going to go option right. And it's Cade Harris to the house. Falcons on the board first.
Outstanding execution by Larrier right there on that little counter option. Pitches it outside.
Kate Harris getting the start. He missed 9 games due to injury last year. He's going to get plenty of time today with the injury to Dane Kinnaman, who won't play in this game. But nobody runs that play better than Air Force.
Nobody. And right there, Harris does a great job. He gets outside. We get a block right there by the lead back. Perfect execution down here in the goal line.
Here comes Matthew DePore for the point after. And we've got a 7-0 ball game early here at Falcons Stadium. Cade Harris and the Zoomies strike first. Let's see what they can do defensively. You're watching Air Force football on Altitude TV.
The algorithm, it's almost guaranteed a touchdown every time.
When he compares telemetry to throwing a perfect spiral, it's just incredible.
Right? So we're all having a lot of fun right now, but don't forget it's hustle.
I don't know how he explains rocket science with just X's and O's, but he's good.
Well, he's one of our veterans, so he has a lot of experience.
Does that mean that he was in the military or that he's been with the team a long time?
And they're gonna do like a banana.
Yes.
Algorithm, right? Now, I'm no rocket scientist, but actually I am.
Did you know that 75% of all aluminum ever produced is still in use today? Which means every time you recycle Ball aluminum packaging, it gets to come back. For every summer barbecue, for every homecoming celebration, and for all the great moments to come. So choose aluminum for your favorite beverages. The future is in your hands. Recycle it.
With Home Chef, you're home free when you're craving a home-cooked meal. Our oven-ready meal kits are easy to make and even easier to love. When it comes to making dinner, fill in the blanks with Home Chef. Delicious, meat simple.
Get 18 free meals when you sign up at homechef.com.
As you well know, the folks at the Air Force Academy are a timely bunch, and they do not waste any time on that opening drive. 5 plays, 26 yards, spanning 2 minutes and 14 seconds, and Cade Harris right there taking it in for the touchdown, and Air Force is up 7-0. Listen, this is one of those games. Again, Air Force under Troy Calhoun has never lost a home opener, and they've never lost to an FCS school. You try and get all the wrinkles wrinkled out today.
Yeah, exactly. And you want to see execution, regardless of who the opponent is. You know, you'd be remiss to not mention the 2 penalties that were right there. Those are plays that Air Force offense is hoping to get.
All right, back for Robert Morris to return this kick. Robert Carter Jr. and Jasa Diakiti. Matthew DePore will let it rip. First one went right through the end zone. The second, ditto. Not returnable. Always a weapon at altitude.
No doubt. Nothing makes a coach happier to see that ball go out the back of the end zone to start a drive.
Did kickers have those kind of legs when you played?
They did. We had a guy named Sean Pavlich that was just outstanding and could put that ball out through the back of the end zone on a consistent basis.
Got to mention, as Robert Morris makes its way back onto the field, they had a wardrobe malfunction to start the game. Their jerseys did not arrive until literally moments before kickoff.
Yeah, I think the captains went out to the 50-yard line with practice jerseys on from Air Force.
Am I thankful they've got numbers on the back of those uniforms, or this would be a long day. Here come the Colonials trying to run this one wide, and it's stopped. Bo Richter, 26 tackles last season. He's played inside, outside, defensive end. He'll do a little bit of everything for you.
Yeah, great job by the front side of this defense, stacking up the blocks, and watch Richter right there slip underneath, make the tackle.
And that's a loss of 3 for Robert Morris. That goes backwards. 2nd and 13 now, as Robert Dickerson couldn't find anywhere to run on that one. Zelkowski under center. He'll stay under center. This one goes up the middle, and Air Force can't make a grab. We've got some room. Kamon O'Sullivan finds a gap, takes it to the outside before Trey Taylor knocks him out of bounds. A gain of 18. What broke down there, Ted?
Yeah, great job right here. Watch. Backside a little bit over pursuit, and then great vision by O'Sullivan right there, finding the crease. They had big block right there on Ramsey. Good job up front by the Colonial offensive line.
Kamon O'Sullivan, one of the few leftovers from last year's offensive group. Very shifty runner, ran for 78 yards last season. That one gave him 18 of them. First and 10, Zukowski, middle of the field. That one is behind his intended target. How tough is it in this transfer portal era? Again, he comes from Albany, Zukowski, but you're reintroducing yourself to a new system. You're introducing yourself to new players. How long does that take?
Yeah, it takes quite a while. And in talking to the coaches the other day, as you recall, they didn't have a whole lot of off-season time to get ready, so the kids themselves had to do some of the workouts on their own.
So now we have a new quarterback in the lineup. They switch it up a little bit. They go to number 14, Zentavious Smith. And somebody lost a helmet, as Zentavious Smith is brought down hard for a loss of two. Trey Taylor coming up to make the pop.
All right, first time we've been able to call number seven's name. He's on a ton of watch lists. Watch Trey Taylor right here. Support on what was starting out to look like a little trickeration. He fills the gap up underneath the block. Great open field tackle.
Did not expect to see Zentavious Smith in the lineup. Clearly they're going to switch out quarterbacks when they have to. PJ Ramsey, by the way, giving some help on that last tackle. This sets up a third and 12 now. And Zukowski doesn't like what he sees. He's looking for a timeout. What didn't he like there, Ted?
Well, it looked like Air Force had brought in an extra defensive back, probably replacing a linebacker. And again, third and 12, you're in a situation here about midfield. You're going to have to put the ball downfield a little bit. And I know that he doesn't want to turn it over, give Air Force easy starting field position on their next drive.
You know, we talk so much about the Air Force offense. They've led the nation in rushing over the last 3 years. But I think the strength of this team, Ted, might be the defense coming into this season.
It really is. I mean, the athleticism on that side, the experience on that side. They've got some kids that have played in some big games, and this defense has been a unit for a while. Led by defensive coordinator Brian Knorr.
Here's a look at the Mountain West preseason poll. Air Force ranked number 2 behind Boise State. Third and 12 now for Zukowski and the RMU offense. Man in motion. Zukowski's got it. He's going to let it rip. This one is going to be short of the sticks, but caught. Never like to catch him short of the sticks. Connor Becker hauls it in, and now you wonder, what do they do near midfield?
Yeah, early on the road, do you go for it? You got really nothing to lose given the situation. It looks like they may just do that.
It's fourth and a short two, and Bernard Clark does not hesitate, did not waste any time. Now he hesitates and wastes time. He thought better. Someone had a talking to. Punter comes in, George Souders, who we have to talk about his mustache, because George Souders, that mustache is a story in itself. It's his sixth year of college football, by the way.
Great. He could be a free agent next year.
6 years. He might be your age.
Very well might be.
That last play is under review. That's what's taking so much time right now. They want to make sure he secured that catch.
Yeah, that was an interesting route right there. He breaks it 2 yards prior to the sticks on a third and long situation, and the ball's a little bit underthrown.
Here's another look.
Ooh, I don't know.
Well, you could see just the tip of that leather, the football touching the turf, but those are so tough to figure out. Is that turf first, arms first?
Yeah,
does it matter?
There wasn't any bobble. He looked like he secured it, but the fact that the ball did hit the ground.
Those are problems you never had in your era, did you? It's either a catch or not.
Well, I mean, they never threw people.
regarding any Air Force passes. There was no constant review in HD quality television.
No, there wasn't. It was either a catch or it wasn't a catch, and I think it's gone both ways over the years.
After review, the ruling on the field of a completed pass stands. Fourth down.
That just delays the inevitable as the Robert Morris punt team comes back onto the field. Souders, the graduate senior, sporting that stash. I was going through the media guide, the Robert Morris media guide, and the transformation of George Souders over the years. Truly something fun to watch. Back to return. This is, let's see who's back there for Air Force. Number 21, Cade Harris. Souders lets it go. Harris, fair catch it there at the 16-yard line. We're going to take a timeout as Air Force stops Robert Morris, and they lead this game 7-0.
The 12th annual Kroenke Sports Charities Give Sports Equipment Drive, presented by Colorado Honda Dealers, is Saturday, September 23rd at Ball Arena. Your donation of new and gently used sports equipment gives underserved children and adults in our community the opportunity to participate in sports. Cash donations are also accepted and support a Precious Child Sports Scholarship Program. Donors will receive a donation receipt and a voucher for two tickets to a predetermined Colorado Avalanche or Denver Nuggets preseason home game while supplies last. Your support gives others the opportunity to get in the game.
At King Soopers, the proven quality of Kroger brand products will make you feel like you're winning. You're sampling the best. And at lower than low prices, you'll save at checkout too. Kroger brand products, guaranteed you'll love the taste or we'll give you your money back. Now that's winning. King Soopers, fresh for everyone.
The new East Club will provide Falcon Stadium with a new and unparalleled setting to take in Air Force football. Reserve your tickets to the new club and experience end-zone-to-end-zone viewing, premium bars, concessions, and two exclusive viewing decks every game day. For more, visit falconathleticfund.com.
There is a very special decal on the Falcons helmet this season. You'll notice an HB79, and it's placed there to honor fallen teammate Hunter Brown. Today's game started with a moment of silence to honor Hunter Brown, who tragically passed away in January after experiencing a medical emergency while leaving his dorm for class. He was a center on this Falcons team, so I spoke with Falcons' current center, Thor Paglialong, about what it means to him, and he told me it's really tough to speak on. Guys, he told me Brown's family has been in the team's thoughts and prayers, and having the initials on the back of the helmet really signifies that we still love him, we're still thinking about him, and it makes putting on the Falcon uniform a little bit more meaningful this season in his honor.
Thanks, Katie. Always emotional when you lose a fellow cadet. Last play there, Zach Larrier gets loose for 24 yards, almost broke it. You give him open field, Ted, watch out.
Yeah, he can jet. With regards to Hunter Brown, to toast, the military folks out there, the Air Force guys will know what I'm saying.
Speaking of jet, Jet Harris in the lineup now at fullback. Got a lot of guys trying to replace Brad Roberts, which is not easy. Option left, Larrier gonna hold on. He's tackled by two different players after a gain of four. Dee Pierce doing the bulk of the work for the Colonials. All right, our King Supers players to watch here, Ted. If you're looking at that Air Force offense, look no further than the quarterback position where it all starts. You don't do it without the QB in this. Oh, Zach Larrier, who can do a little bit of everything, but running is his specialty.
Yeah, no doubt. You already mentioned two-time Western Athletic, Mountain West champion.
Larrier's going to hand it off up the middle, and this one goes for about 5 yards as Emmanuel Michelle makes his first carry of the new season. Michelle, who was one of their leading rushers last year, found out he was cleared by the NCAA on Thursday. They didn't know he'd be able to play.
Yeah, E-Man, as they call him. Outstanding runner on the inside. Good job right there with the vision. Bouncing it out a little bit. You're going to see work by both Burke and Michelle at that fullback position. Another position that I mentioned that we need to watch.
Michelle remains in the game. They're going to give it right back to him. And Emmanuel Michelle, the senior, churns for another Air Force first down.
Comes up limping a little bit there.
He'll get tended to on the sideline as Greg Davis popped him there off tackle. See if he can shake that off. Again, this is a new look backfield for Air Force Academy without Zeke Daniels, Brad Roberts. Now you got the likes of Owen Burke behind Larrier. Larrier's going to throw it. He's got a man. And it's between two men, incomplete.
Larrier threw that ball with some authority, but just a little bit high for the intended receiver. Let's watch it on replay.
I think he was shooting for number 18, Kendon Alexander. Alexander couldn't reach it, but in the vicinity was Wyatt Wilson.
Might have been a little bit of a mix-up on the routes there.
So an early pass attempt for the Air Force Academy. Sets up a second and 10 now. Ball across midfield. Pitch left. Got some room. Knocked out of bounds for a gain of about 7. Call it 8. Aiden Calvert. It's his first carry of the game, the junior out of Mater Dei High School.
You know, Vic, this is what drives opponents crazy when you play an Air Force offense. You do a great job on the inside with the fullback game, and what do? They take it to the outside to one of their outstanding running backs right there with a lead blocker out front, and they're in a third and short situation.
Third and a long one, Air Force. With a flag. Let's see if this is a... Looks like there's some movement on the Air Force offensive line.
Start with 13. Offense, 5-yard penalty. Still third down.
All right, a false start's going to push it back a little bit. Jared Rosnos got off the line of scrimmage a little too quickly. So now we're going to go to a 3rd and 6. Air Force perfect on third down situations thus far in this game.
Again, those are the types of things that will drive you crazy as a coach. You got a 3rd and 1, short situation about midfield. You're moving the ball consistently, and then a mental mistake puts you in a 3rd and long.
Larrier, he'll run it. He's looking for some room. He crosses the yellow line and crosses the 30 for another Air Force first down. Great patient run. Deer Pierce brings him down, a gain of 14.
Vic, you hit the nail on the head. Watch him right here, patience. This is a draw all the way. He drops back, tries to get that linebacker and secondary to commit to their routes downfield, and then uses those quick feet and that vision inside to find the crease and convert the first down on 3rd down.
Emmanuel Michelle back in the lineup now. He's gonna get the ball up the middle, and Michelle's gonna grind behind his offensive lineman for about 3 yards. Jamar Chagog, number 1 for Robert Morris, comes up with the tackle.
Good job right there by Michelle. You look at that play, and from the outside may think, well, it's only 3 yards, or, you know, it's 2nd and 7. But those are the types of plays that the Falcons use to grind and to wear a defense down. And it's great to see Michelle back in there after having limped off.
Michelle stays in there now for the 2nd and 6. Larrier, he'll keep it left. He'll cut inside. Zach Larrier to the house. 26-yard touchdown.
You have got to love that. Zach Larrier. Watch here on the replay. Outstanding job in getting this ball. This is his carry all the way. He's got a lead blocked by Michelle out there on the corner. And then just that little nuance of body movement, being able to cut out and come back up underneath. First touchdown of the season, and one that I'm sure that we'll be calling many, many more.
Here's the point after for Matthew Lepore. And Air Force starting to pour it on. 14-0 here at Falcon Stadium. About 3.5 to play in the first quarter. They're zooming, all right.
America, it's time to gear up and get out there in a new Ford vehicle. And it all starts at your local Ford dealer during the Discover Summer Sales Event. Choose from a great selection of trucks and SUVs equipped with the tech and comfort you need to discover your best summer ever. With a large inventory in stock, now is the best time to trade in, trade up, and discover summer with Ford. Now buy or lease a select 2023 Ford SUV and get $1,000 trade assist cash plus financing as low as 0.9. Only at your local Ford stores.
Are you looking for more in this world? Are you driven by purpose? Then we are looking for you, the big-hearted, the bold, the change makers. We are the Peace Corps. With volunteers in more than 60 countries, we join hands with communities, live together, work together, transform lives, and serve boldly, together. Are you ready to go the distance to make a difference? Then we have a place where you belong. Join us.
They said I'll never run. Now I run marathons. They said I'll never have a job. Today, I work with global leaders. They said I'll never speak. Now I give speeches to hundreds of people at a time. They said I would never walk. Now I can jump 6 meters. The skills of people with intellectual disabilities go way beyond sports. We will defy your expectation. Help us build a more inclusive world.
Welcome back to the Academy. Katie's getting her work in. I said, did you work out today? Nah, I'll do it at the game. This is what the cadets do.
Quick upper body workout down here. We'll see, already 14 points on the board, so I might have a long day ahead of me. I'm still catching my breath, but it always amazes me, one, how committed the cadets are to this, guys, but also how quickly they can crank out push-ups. I can't keep up.
How many did you end up doing last year on the opener against Northern Iowa?
I blacked it out. I don't remember.
Yeah.
It was a lot.
Well, again, if you need a prime upper body workout, just attend an Air Force game and hang out with the cadets. Trust me, you'll get your work in. 14-zip as LaPorte puts another one through the back of the end zone, and here come the Robert Morris Colonials trying to put something on the board. This was the lowest scoring team, by the way, in FCS last year, averaging under 10 points a game. It has not been an easy trek for Coach Clark and that Colonial offense.
Yeah, it really hasn't, and it looks like, at least offensively, they're trying to put their big playmakers, or at least the guys they feel like have that capability, into some positions outside to throw on the outside quick pass and trying to do some various isolation type plays to break them into the open field. One big run, but so far that's about it.
Day-Day Jones behind Tyler Zukowski in the backfield. Zukowski gonna let this one rip. He'll go to the short side. That's one of the more productive plays so far the afternoon. Tackled by Jonathan Youngblood and Gamby Goff.
And again, just trying to get the ball out into the open field and then try to let their, what I like to call, renegade speed. The old JUCO guys that you just didn't really know what to do with at the next level. That's who they went after here at Robert Morris. And they've got that renegade speed, so to speak. Can they bring it all together into some kind of, you know, standard attack?
Ton of transfers on that Robert Morris side. Zukowski has time, and he'll throw this one away. Play broke down there in the flats. Air Force made it break down.
Great job by that Air Force secondary. They did a great job out there in the flat, wide side of the field, dropping back. Zukowski is not a run threat.
Watch James Tomasi here, number 62. Forced the quick action. Here comes third down for Robert Morris. They're 0 for 2 on the big play. Third down, ball's on the 29-yard line. Zukowski with two wide on each side. One in the backfield. Whistle on the field, and there's a flag. Looks like movement down the, or timeout.
Second out of the half, Robert Morris. 30 seconds.
Bernard Clark wants to talk this one over.
I
Always a fun day here on campus for the opener at Falcon Stadium. Vic Lombardi and Ted Sundquist, along with Katie Wingy, calling this game. Parents Weekend makes it special, doesn't it?
Yeah, it really does. And again, we mentioned it earlier on. If you're a freshman, you haven't seen your family or friends since June when they dropped you off and shaved your head. And if you're a senior, you're getting ready to go on the last year of a journey that's going to lead you on to that second lieutenant. So it is. It's an emotional weekend and a lot of fun for the cadets.
And I asked you, every cadet is required to attend the football game.
They are. It's a military formation, so they've got to be here, unless you're on another sports team that might be traveling this weekend as well.
One of the rare colleges in the country where you know every student is at the game. Here we go. Sets up a third down. Third and six. Zukowski back to pass, and he is dropped. What a play up the middle on the blitz. A loss of seven.
Watch here, Ramsey. He's one of the front three. They drop eight, and he just beats that left tackle. Makes an outside move and then rips back up underneath. And that's part of that pressure that I talked about as a key to the game for the Air Force defense. Great job by Ramsey with the one-on-one sack.
And they're expecting big things out of P.J. Ramsey this year. Trey Taylor said, watch out. He is long and strong. He made huge strides in the offseason. That forces a Robert Morris punt. And usually when you're punting the Air Force, watch out. It almost happened, nearly blocked. It'll be fair caught at about the 36-yard line. They nearly got to him. George Souders, the punter, is still down. He's calling for a penalty.
Yeah, it looked like the official signaled that the ball was tipped. Once that ball's tipped, and that punter's pretty much free game, and he was run into, but the fact that they were able to get their hand on the ball, a little bit of acting job there, but you know punters.
Jerome Gaylord, number 22 for the Falcons, he almost could have caught that before he got to the foot. First down for the Falcons, leading 14-0. Larrier still at quarterback. Owen Burke behind him. Gonna rip it out to John Lee Eldridge, who finds the sideline. Knocked out of bounds. Time now for the Intermountain Health Power of We, helping people live the healthiest lives possible. This is what we're talking about when we mention the power of We. It's the machine that is Air Force offense.
You know, and Vic, you asked how Coach Calhoun had done these double-digit winning seasons for so many years in a row. Look no further than the rushing of the football right there. He's able to control the football game on the ground.
Last year, they led the country in rushing by nearly 90 yards, which is unfathomable. Second and six. Larrier fakes it inside, and he'll sit down for about a yard. Set up another third down for the Falcons. Great defense there by Seth Verilis, who came up to make the stop. Larrier in this game so far, six rushes, 79 yards. He just needs a gap. See if he can find one here.
Vic, I tell you what, I'm impressed early on with Zach Larrier's grasp of the offense and what they're trying to do. You can tell that he's audible and up on the line of scrimmage, getting him into the best play, making good reads, getting the ball to the right guys.
Third and five for the Falcons. They'll keep it up the middle. Second effort there, not quite good enough. It's going to stay about a yard short as Owen Burke gets up to about the 44-yard line. D. Pierce comes up to make the tackle for Robert Morris.
Yeah, look right here, a little inside zone. He bounces it out. Just comes up about a yard short. This is normal for Air Force now. They're going to come out, and they're going to try to pressure you on fourth down.
Fourth and two, the Academy. They're trying to get him off sides, or will they run a play? They'll run it. And this play will not get there. Jamar Chagog read it all along, the linebacker. 5 years at Robert Morris. He's a fifth-year senior. Says he wants to become a data analyst. Well, he read all the data and made the play there.
Yeah, he certainly did. And he also wanted to match violence with violence. And Air Force is coming at you on fourth down. He makes the big play.
Early gamble for the Falcons. Robert Morris has it in Falcons territory when we come back.
The future of business banking technology. First Bank presents Sarah.
It's just Sarah.
Available in black suit, blue suit, and casual Fridays.
Yay, Fridays.
Features include human interaction, empathy, and actually caring about your business.
The technology you need, the humans you want.
Oh, hi.
First Bank. Business banking for good.
The Pikes Peak Apex is a multi-day cycling and running event. Heuberger Subaru has been here since the very beginning. When we founded the event in 2020, they were right there as a founding level partner. They also understand, like us, that we've got this amazing network of trails here in the Pikes Peak region. Building more trails for more people and maintaining those trails throughout the year is really important to them as it is us. And that's really kind of in line with what we're doing with the Pikes Peak Apex. We want to get out on those trails and create adventures.
Basketball has taught me a lot. Teamwork, determination, confidence, how to win and how to lose, how to get up and keep going. Basketball taught me how to be a leader. 80% of women leaders played sports growing up, but girls drop out of sports twice as often as boys. Let's help our girls lean into sports and leadership.
Explorers don't see a world with limits. With an innovative spirit and curious mind, they never stop wondering what tomorrow may hold. Boeing was built by explorers, and our growing global team is helping reimagine the future of aerospace and making our world safer and more sustainable. Join us as we take flight together.
Air Force football is brought to you by First Bank. For over 59 years, First Bank is always rooted for the home team. First Bank, banking for good, member FDIC. And by Heuberger Subaru. Second quarter, first play, right out of the chute, goes nowhere for Robert Morris. They tried the end around, the little jet sweep. And there's a flag on the play. Again, Robert Morris, ball across midfield because Air Force failed to convert that fourth and two. TJ Ramsey and Jonathan Youngblood combining for that last tackle.
Yeah, Air Force hoping to draw that defense off sides. Good job by the Columbia.
Illegal block in the back, number 21, offense. That penalty is declined. Second down.
Gives them great field position off of what more or less is a turnover and what Coach Calhoun is trying to avoid today. But the Air Force defense does a great job getting upfield right there and forcing that end around.
Robert Morris will try it again. Tyler Zukowski, the transfer from Albany, in at quarterback. He's got some help in the backfield. Third and 14. Second and 14, I should say, sets up a third and 14, because that play goes nowhere. Alec Mock, one of three very, very experienced linebackers.
Nice job by Mock right off the edge right there. Read it really well, put himself in position. Strong wrap up tackle. Some good fundamental defense right now being played by the Falcons early in this ball game and early in the season.
0 for 3 on third down of the Colonials. They give another go at it here. It's third and 14. Ball at the 49. Zukowski. Gonna put this one in the air. Quick toss out right and sniff out right away. Nowhere to go, nowhere to hide. Great play by Jerome Gaylear Jr.
Hey, by Jerome Gaylear.
And it looks like we've got an injury to Zukowski after he released that ball. Let's take another look. Zukowski was hit low, and the trainers for Robert Morris are out talking.
Oh, goodness.
Purely incidental. Kupono Blake was driven into his knee there. That knee that's bracing, and that does not look good for Tyler Zukowski. We're going to take a timeout here as the trainers tend to the RMU quarterback. You're watching Air Force football on Altitude TV.
Teddy Roosevelt once said, "It is not the critic who counts, not the man who points out how the strong man stumbles. The credit belongs to the man who is actually in the arena, whose face is marred by dust and sweat and blood, and comes up short again and again, because there is no effort without error or shortcoming, who spends himself in a worthy cause. Do you have grit?"
5-Hour Energy. Think of it as 5-second coffee for when you wake up too late to make it, or you don't have time to wait in line for it, or you're just too busy for a coffee break. 5-Hour Energy, the 5-second coffee.
The Tree Farm's 50 cent tree sale. Buy the first tree at regular price and get a second tree for 50
you
cents.
You take I-25 to exit 235, then 5 miles west to the tree farm.
I'ma put in
work. Good job!
By his man, Murray on the move.
Yes!
Great bounce pass to Brown. Jokic for the win! Yes! And the Nuggets have won it!
Unfortunate news here for Robert Morris quarterback Tyler Zukowski. He was hit low after he released the football. Had to be helped off the field. As you can see, Ted, he can't put any pressure on that left leg.
Yeah, that didn't look good at all. And, you know, the Air Force defender was blocked into him, but he had already released that ball, and that leg was out, fully extended. Looked like hyperextension.
Robert Morris forced to punt. And that one will go right through the end zone. So a quarterback change coming for Robert Morris. Meanwhile, Robert Morris, first time this year that Robert Morris, and only time, they will get to fly an airplane to a game.
Wow.
Everything else is on a bus.
That tells you this is probably the farthest trip that they've taken in quite some time. I was wondering if they'd even been west of the Mississippi anytime lately.
Zach Larrier back at quarterback for the Falcons. Emmanuel Michelle behind him at fullback. Larrier will keep it left. He's trying to find a window, and he will lose yardage. By the way, Zach Larrier is the first Falcons quarterback to wear the number 9 since Troy Calhoun under Fisher DeBerry, who wore the number 9 at quarterback in 1986, the opener against Hawaii. Look at Troy go. They beat Hawaii 24-17. Look at Troy throw the ball.
Let's just say this. Troy Calhoun may be the smartest quarterback that's ever played the position, but not necessarily the fastest.
Who would have known? The future head coach of the Falcons, Larrier, on second down will throw. Wide open over the middle is Jared Rosnos, and Rosnos is gone. 84 yards, and there is the danger of the Air Force offense. They pop you with the run, they hit you in the head, and then the hammer laid down with a pass.
That's exactly right, Vic. Watch them right here. It's run, 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 and then all of a sudden, that wing receiver just heads straight up the field, makes a little break to the inside on the post, and 84 yards later, it's a touchdown.
How about the throw by Larrier right on the money?
Very patient, nice delivery, good spiral, put it right there so he can run right to it.
Of course, there was no RMU player within a zip code of the receiver. Makes it a ton easier. 21-0, Air Force dominating. Robert Morris here at Falcon Stadium.
Of the Commander in Chief's Trophy.
Touchdown!
Bring it home.
Jared Rosenhaus, his first career touchdown for the Falcons. The 6 foot junior out of Sacramento gets wide, and I mean wide open, over the middle of the field, and he takes it 84 yards for the touch. I think the tough part there, Ted, is making sure you just catch the football.
Making sure you catch the football. I like the route. I think he did a great job coming off the line of scrimmage, pressing his defender. They're dropping in zone, and then he makes a little break to the inside right there. That free safety's worried about the other side of the field, and he's wide open. You're exactly right. Then it was nothing but, hey, catch this thing.
This kick will be fielded. Robert Carter Jr.'s got it at the 20 to the 25, still on his feet. He'll tiptoe to the 27. And a new quarterback in for Robert Morris as their starter, Tyler Zukowski, left with a leg injury. And they're going to bring in one of last year's quarterbacks. They had two they played most of last season. We shall see who gets the nod. It's Anthony Chickett, the 6'2 redshirt junior. An amazing story we'll get into about Anthony Chickett. He'll line up with Kamano Sullivan at his side. Tayshawn Mayfield also in the backfield with a little support. Chickett to O'Sullivan. And this one goes nowhere, maybe a yard if they're lucky. Anthony Chickett played 4 games last year before he got hurt. This man has overcome so much. He's a 2-time Hodgkin's lymphoma survivor. Lost his mother in 2021. You talk about the study of perseverance. There it is right there.
Yeah, this guy just walking on the field is an inspiration to his teammates. And now he's put in a tough spot here, coming in as the number two, down by 21.
Here comes the blitz. Chickett over the middle. He's got his target. And it's going to be short of the first down. A great open field tackle there by Gamby Goff. A gain of 6 to James Westry.
You watch Chickett right here. He drops back, sees the blitz coming. He stands in there, takes the hit. Nice delivery right here. Quick release.
Now comes the hard part, third down.
There you go, caught that crossing route that came up just a little bit short. But they're in a good situation, third and short.
Third and 3 for Robert Morris. They're 0-for-4 on third downs in this game. Chickett, he'll dump it out to his back. And this is gonna be right on the line. It'll be close depending on the spot. Did Kamano Sullivan get to the first down marker? You see the Robert Morris players. They're waving first down, and it looks like it is. They're moving the chains right now. So nice conservative play call and moves the chains for the Colonials.
Yeah, good job by Chickett. He looks to his right. He sees the heat coming. He dumps it off to his back. Does a nice job of cutting back up against the grain right there into the oncoming defenders, and is able to convert the first down.
Chickett under center now. He'll hand it off. And there was nowhere to run, nowhere to hide. Day-Day Jones could not find daylight as Trey Taylor comes up to make the stick.
Trey Taylor playing that free safety position on so many All-American watch lists. This guy can play all over the football field, against the run, against the pass. Watch him right here. Good job on the inside, stacking up that offensive line. And then Taylor just coming off the edge in support, sticking that helmet in there, making a great open field tackle.
Second and 10. Anthony Chickett. He'll pass this one. Swing pass. And that one is blown up. Boy, Air Force read that all along. Couple players coming up to make the stop. Jamari Bellamy blew it up from the outside. A gain of 2.
Yeah, so far the Colonials have tried to get that ball out there to either side with little swing passes and just have not had any luck. Air Force too quick coming up on the support, both by their linebackers and by their defenders.
Here's their offensive coordinator, Josh Firm. His first year as an OC. See what he dials up here on 3rd and 12. They converted their last third down. Bit more challenging this time around. Anthony Chickett, flags flying everywhere. And it looks like another illegal procedure.
False start on the offense. Not all players were set prior to snap. It's a 5-yard penalty. Still 3rd down.
You know, Vic, that's just a timing issue. Chickett probably didn't get most of the reps during the week in practice. He comes in, it's a different cadence. The kids haven't heard him in a while behind the behind center, and they get a jump right there.
Well, that sets up the always enviable 3rd and 17. You know Air Force is coming. What do you dial up here, Teddy?
Well, it'll be interesting to see if they do bring four or if they drop off the outside linebacker. They bring four.
Over the middle, wide receiver screen will bring it back to the original line of scrimmage, but well short as Cupono Blake works the backside to make the tackle, and that forces a Robert Morris punt.
That was an outstanding play by Blake right there. I mean, he's off that front line, right, trying to create pressure, and then drops off and makes the tackle. Great effort.
Well, George Souders, the sixth-year senior, is going to be a busy man today. Three punts already for a 41.3-yard average. I'd say they all like kicking at altitude. Here's his 4th punt of the afternoon, fielded and muffed. But there's an Air Force player to pick it up. Wow, that was danger zone. Trey Williams, right place at the right time. Air Force maintains possession. They're up 21.
The future of business banking technology. First Bank presents Sarah.
It's just Sarah.
Available in black suit, blue suit, and casual Fridays.
Yay, Fridays.
Features include human interaction, empathy, and actually caring about your business.
The technology you need, the humans you want.
Oh, hey.
First Bank. Business banking for good.
The Pikes Peak Apex is a multi-day cycling and running event. Heuberger Subaru has been here since the very beginning. When we founded the event in 2020, they were right there as a founding level partner. They also understand, like us, that we've got this amazing network of trails here in the Pikes Peak region. Building more trails for more people and maintaining those trails throughout the year is really important to them as it is us. And that's really kind of in line with what we're doing with the Pikes Peak Apex. We want to get out on those trails and create adventures.
To the Academy, where the Air Force Falcons have a 21-0 lead in the second quarter over Robert Morris. I'm holding in my hands one of the most valuable possessions that you can find in the Air Force Falcons locker room. It is the Diesel hat, and the Diesel is what the Falcons refer to the offensive line as. Legend has it that these hats were found at a truck stop, and a former Falcons player's mom helped secure 20 to 25 of these. Now, who has these? The offensive line. And why do they call themselves the Diesel? Because diesel engines are consistent. They go to work. They show up and do their job every single day. The really cool thing about these hats, guys, is the O-line can award them to other players on this Falcon team that they think have that same mentality, that bring their pail and go to work every single day. So these, if you can get your hands on these, it is a hot commodity for the Air Force Falcons. I was told that if I don't return this, I will be in big, big trouble.
As well, you should be. Do your push-ups, Katie. You owe us 42 of them today.
It's 21-0.
Well, don't you have to do them every time they score?
I guess adding them all up. Yeah, you're right.
Thank you.
You're right. I take back what I said.
Sets up a 2nd and 7 for the Falcons. Larrier's going to keep it. Cannot escape. And that's going to be down for about a 1-yard gain. Jamar Chagog is having himself a game for Robert Morris, the fifth-year senior linebacker.
You know, that Diesel story is outstanding because you look at those statistics that we saw earlier in year after year after year after year. You see ranked number one, number two. It goes back to the play of that offensive line.
We've got a third and four for the Falcons. And then there's a timeout on the field. Timeout Air Force. They're going to talk this one over. Is that OC Mike Thiessen not liking what he saw?
Yeah, something there. Probably early on wanting to make sure they're in the right formation or the guys know what they need to do.
By the way, how rare is that for the head coach to have his play caller at his side for this long? I mean, but that's what the academy does. 10 coaches from the academy working for the academy.
Yeah, that's outstanding. And to be quite honest with you, like you said, very unusual. I think the number two team is five, maybe. But you've got a situation where a culture has been built here, Vic, over decades, not just years, but decades. And it started with Ken Hatfield, my coach, that went on to Fisher DeBerry, and Troy Calhoun has carried it on.
Third and four for the Falcons, Zach Larrier. Let's see what they dial up for this one. Larrier, option right. He'll keep. And this one is good enough for a first down. A gain of six. 6 yards on the ground for Zach Larrier, who is having quite the day. By the way, if you're wondering, yards per play so far, averaging almost 10 yards per play, Air Force is. Robert Morris is at just under two per play. So there's the disparity in the rushing attacks. First down for the Academy. Emmanuel Michelle now at fullback. Option left. There's an interesting pitch. Didn't work. John Lee Eldridge swallowed up, and you saw him. Larrier just threw that.
Yeah, he did. I think that's a situation where you go back and look at tape, like we're going to see here on the replay. The coaches are going to say, hey, sometimes you just got to eat it. You're down here deep in your own territory, and you're trying to dump it off. I get what he's wanting to do, but at the same time, you don't want to risk a fumble and a turnover this deep.
Seth Verlis forced it out of his hand, and William Barber made the tackle for RMU. We got second and 15 now. Larrier going back to the air. He'll keep it on the ground. Flags everywhere as he gets to the 30-yard line. Jamar Chagag with another tackle after a gain of 10. Looks like they're going to call a defensive hold on Robert Morris. Again, Larrier had time there, didn't like what he saw down the field, and decided to tuck and run, but
holding, number zero, defense. It's a 10-yard penalty for the end of the run, an automatic. First down.
That's a hold on Garrett Fairman.
Well, a little counteraction there, and I think they were trying to run a post flag, and the timing just wasn't right. Larrier tucks it underneath and takes off, but the timing may have been messed up because of the defensive holding.
First down for the Falcons. Approaching midfield. 21-0 advantage. Give it up the middle. Got some room. That's Owen Burke. A gain of 12. Check that. Aiden Calvert with the run. 5'10", 205-pound junior.
Well, I like this play right here. It cuts back against the grain, and Calvert finds that hole with great vision. Watch him right here cut and then cover up that ball for a big gain.
They use a variety of fullbacks. We were so used to Brad Roberts inside and outside last year. Now they got three or four of them. Zach Larrier is going to keep this one on the ground. He's lassoed down inside the 45-yard line. Dee Pierce makes the stick. Dee Pierce is everywhere.
Yeah, he really is. Great job by Pierce right there, kind of in a free safety position. Middle of the field, classic alignment, and he's able to get outside and make the open field tackle on the speedy Larrier. Good job by the Colonial defense right there.
Busy day for Larrier. 11 carries, 95 yards. He's already approaching the century mark before halftime. Second down. Larrier keeps it behind the big guys, and he gets to about the 30, I'd say the 40-yard line. That's going to be short. Tyler King, the transfer out of Stony Brook. Again, this Robert Morris defense littered with transfers as Tyler King comes up to make the stop, and it sets up another third down.
Yeah, again, the Falcon offense right here just wearing out the Colonials. These 2 and 3 yard gains don't look big, but they eventually wear on you, especially visiting team to altitude.
Third and two. Three behind Larrier in the backfield. Give up the middle. Emmanuel Michel, second effort, gets the first down. Shakespeare Lewis makes that tackle. Come to find out, number nine there, Shakespeare. Don't like his first name, so he's going with Shakespeare, his middle name.
Well, good job by Shakespeare right here, because if he misses the tackle, Michelle's gone to the house for a long touchdown at that fullback position. But he gets down there and wraps his arms around those tree trunks of Michelle.
Larrier back to pass. He'll go to the flats this time, and a great connection with Jared Rosnos, who hauled in that 84-yarder earlier. Jasa Diakiti with the defense. That's a gain of 11 for Larrier. Larrier much more adept as a passer than I imagined.
Yeah, he really is, and what I like is how quickly he's getting his feet set and releasing the football.
Chains are moving. They keep it on the ground, and this one is going in. Owen Burke, the senior, to the end zone.
Nice run by Owen Burke right there. That was shades of Brad Roberts. Great vision. And watch him right here on the replay. Inside zone, pops it outside. Nice vision. Got the speed to take it to the end zone. But that's all Burke. Nice cut.
That angle gave us a great look at the misdirection of that Air Force offense, because you saw a lot of the Robert Morris guys going the other way, and they had no chance.
They really didn't.
Matthew DePore with the point after, and Air Force is putting it on. It is 28-0. Parents weekend here at Falcon Stadium. Falcons are having a field day.
They really are. So far, not a lot of those early game jitters that you sometimes see out of teams when they come out the first week. You can tell Air Force, even though that there have been some changes on that offensive side, have done a great job in preparing. You don't see, you know, missed exchanges. I think that Larrier's doing a great job of putting them in the right plays. They're taking advantage of their formations and movement. And that defense is just putting, like I said before, pressure, pressure, pressure on the Colonial offense.
I did not see Katie in the mix there doing push-ups. I think she's given up. She did 208 of them, by the way, we're told, last season. So she knows to preserve her energy today. It's already 28-0. Katie, anything to say for yourself?
Well, it's been a very high-scoring first half, so I do have to pick my places where I want to go and do push-ups, because there's no way, if this continues, that I could have done all of the rounds that will take place. So I will go back in the second half, which that will be a lot to do at one time, but stay tuned. That's getting the viewer to stay tuned for the second half right there.
How
what
about
a tease.
We let you do sit-ups instead of push-ups if you like. You get
I don't
choice.
Know. No excuses. Okay. I will be doing push-ups.
28-0 cushion for the Falcons. This one is going to be run right from the goal line, and there is a little bit of room up the middle. Robert Carter Jr. to the 25. For Robert Morris, they'll give it another go. Unable to really move the ball against this stout Air Force defense. Time now for the Ball Corporation. Future is in your hands. Recycle it. Look at some of the big fellas on this squad. Thor Pagley along the center. He is a preseason All-Mountain West. So is Peyton Zadroik, who's not playing today. He's got a shoulder injury, along with John Lee Eldridge and Alec Mock. So a lot of guys on this squad expected to do great things in the conference.
Well, you win 10 games in back-to-back seasons and in bowl games and hold the Commander-in-Chief's trophy, you're going to get looked at.
Hand off right side. Chickett gives it up to his running back, and this is good for about 4 yards. Kamano Sullivan. Trey Taylor comes up to make the stop. Actually, a 6-yard gain sets up a second and 4.
In the situation right there with Trey Taylor having to come up and make the play like that, short second down.
stacked backfield for Robert Morris, the Colonials. Chicken hands it off left. Some daylight and another first down for the Colonials. Starting to move the ball slowly but surely. Gamby Goff comes up to make the tackle after a gain of five. So two productive run plays. I mean, if you're Bernard Clark and the Colonials and you're down 28-0, you sort of want to get that clock going. Keep the clock running. Keep it running the best you can before the half. First down, Robert Morris. Quick pass, Anthony Chickett finds a receiver. Chickett to James Westry, and that's good for about two. Seconds and counting before the half. Robert Morris not especially in a hurry here to move the ball down the field. I think they're content with where they're at. Chickett gets him in the huddle. This will be the last play of the first half. Anthony Chickett up the middle, give it to O'Sullivan, and that'll be stopped for no gain as the Air Force defense continues to flex its muscle. They pitch a shutout in the first half. It's 28-0 here at the Academy. We knew it wouldn't be easy for the Colonials, but it sure looks easy for Air Force. Let's go downstairs to Katie Wingy. Katie.
All right, thank you very much. Coach, you talked about how physical your practices had been leading up to this game. How do you think that transferred in the first half?
I think obviously defensively how well we play blocks, you know, that's evident. You know, really, you make each side makes each other better, you know, and just it starts with pad level. Still certainly a good number of mistakes that we got to get fixed. We got to be able to convert on a short yard, especially when we choose to go for it on fourth down.
How pleased were you with Zach Larrier and what he did at that QB spot to start?
Well, I mean, really, for the most extensive action that he's ever had at that position, I mean, really, really good poise, delivered a good ball on the, you know, on the big play and then on the sideline out route, too. So a couple of things were a little hairy in there. The pitch, you know, it looked like Kareem Abdul-Jabbar shooting a sky hook there. I don't know if we want that.
Good luck in the second. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Vic.
Thank you, Katie. A lot to like out of Zach Larrier. He's near the century mark and running the ball. He's got 28 points on the board, and the Falcons are cruising. It's halftime here at Falcon Stadium. You're watching Altitude TV.
Summer won't last forever, but with a great selection of vehicles during Toyota's national sales event, there's still time to capture new memories.
Hey, how are you?
With friends and family. Before it all flies by.
Right now, lease a 2023 Tundra for $489 per month. Or get 3.99% APR for up to 48 months on a new 2023 Tacoma.
Come in today.
Toyota, let's go places.
On your beat, and welcome your Denver
After your 9-to-5, your 5-to-9 should be easy. As easy as Home Chef's Fast and Fresh Meals. Relax during the home stretch with a meal filled with fresh, pre-portioned ingredients while your microwave or oven does all the work so you can clean your plate and skip the cleanup after. Get dinner done quicker with Home Chef's Fast and Fresh Meals so you can spend your 5-to-9 however you want to. Delicious meets simple. Get 18 free meals at homechef.com.
We've been here for more than 36 years. At the forefront of a quest that many consider science fiction. To understand the prevalence of life in the universe. Because the discovery of life beyond Earth will lay the framework for humanity's next steps to the stars. We are the SETI Institute.
2018 lacrosse national champion Christian Gaudy for the FDA's Don't Get Burned Sunscreen Challenge.
Bring it, Daryl.
She's tough, but I won't get burned today. I'm using a broad-spectrum sunscreen.
The FDA recommends broad-spectrum sunscreens with an SPF of 15 or higher with other sun protection measures to reduce the risk of sunburn and skin cancer.
You smoke me, Kristen.
That's because I use sunscreen, so I wouldn't get burned by you and the sun.
Broad-spectrum sunscreen. It's a winning play every time.
Falcons soaring here at Falcon Stadium, 28-0 over Robert Morris. Once a Falcon, always a Falcon. In fact, I found one at Broncos headquarters. Joe Lombardi, the Broncos offensive coordinator. He spent two seasons as a tight end here at the Academy, 92-93, 18 years as an NFL assistant. Of course, he won a Super Bowl with Sean Payton in New Orleans as the quarterback's coach. And now he's running the offensive operation up in Denver. Got a chance to chat some Air Force football with Coach Lombardi. Here with former Air Force tight end and Air Force lacrosse star, Joe Lombardi. So why tight end when you got to the academy? Was that always your position or did they move you there?
Yeah, no, I was recruited as a tight end. Okay. So yeah, I kind of started and finished there.
Well, I noticed that you're a big Lombardi. Most of us Lombardis are small. Your grandfather was on the, seven blocks of granite? That's right. What they called it?
Yeah, seven blocks of granite at Fordham.
And he was not your size. How'd you get so big?
That must be from my mom's side. And my dad's only about 5'9", so, yeah, I don't know how it happened, but got lucky.
Your time at the academy, you have said many times how that set you up for life. What did it do? How did it define Joe Lombardi?
Oh, you know, a number of things. I think there's just, you know, a discipline there. You have to have every day. You know, there's no off days at the academy, so I just think it builds a certain stamina for work. Mm-hmm. That you every day you have to wake up and do your job. You know, I think the people you're surrounded with at the academy, you know, there's a lot of there's a lot of leaders there and a lot of people that you learn from, and I think a lot of your character is formed by the people you surround yourself with, and generally speaking, the guys that you're surrounded with and girls that you're surrounded with at the academy are high quality people.
How long do those relationships and friendships last?
Forever. Yeah, I mean, most of my best friends are from those college days, and it's been nice getting back to Colorado because a lot of those guys are hanging around here, so it's good to catch up with a lot of those guys.
When I was a child, people used to say to me, "Vic Lombardi, any relation?" And I say, "Yeah. Yeah, he was my grandfather." But you really are the grandson of one of the greatest of all time. And I know you don't take that lightly. But when did coaching become an option for you, knowing that Vince Lombardi's the ultimate coach?
So my dad wanted a coach. And my grandfather said, "No, you're going to be a lawyer." So he became a lawyer. And a lot like his dad, my dad was like, "Don't coach." So you don't go to the Air Force Academy thinking you're going to coach. But after graduation and those first couple seasons came around that, for the first time since I can remember, I wasn't part of a football team. I really missed it and felt like something was missing. So that's when I kind of got the bug. My oldest son is senior year of college, and he's decided he wants to coach, and I've tried to talk him out of it, but I wasn't successful either. So we'll see how that goes.
What's crazy, Joe, when I look at these photos, and I'm looking at Moranis' book, and obviously these books are all written differently, but this book resonated with me because of the photos. But your dad and your face, I mean, you look like Vince Lombardi in the face, except the gap in the teeth.
That's right, yeah.
But you've been told that?
More my dad looks a lot like him, and people see that comparison a little bit more. I've been told I look like my dad a little bit more, but yeah, I suppose there's some resemblance.
Do you have a Vince Lombardi quote that's your favorite, or do you even
I do. I think, he talked to the team. He said there should be three things in your life: faith, family, and football. And, as long as you keep those things, the main thing, in that order, things will be all right. So I like, kind of that anchor that he set, like, hey, when things are maybe feeling a little bit hectic, man, you just pay attention to those three things and try to keep those right, and everything will turn out all right.
When we come back, an Air Force quarterback who actually played with Joe Lombardi. Look at the Falcons, 28-0.
Hi, I'm Ed Harris, proud supporter of DAV, Disabled American Veterans.
If this year has shown us anything, it's how important it is that we take care of one another. It has been especially challenging for our disabled veterans who are in need of critical health care and benefits.
By joining the military during a very active period of war, I absolutely went into it with the idea that I could die. Both my legs were amputated due to an IED that I sustained while I was deployed to Iraq. I mean, I'm still here, so there must be something more.
There's never been a greater time to show your support for our nation's greatest heroes.
There were moments of frustration where you can't do this anymore, you can't go here anymore. I absolutely felt like I lost some of my purpose.
For 100 years, our heroes on the battlefield who gave and lost so much have been able to count on DAV because of our donor heroes who give every month. Even though our history is long, the future is uncertain. We need a new generation of donors to stand with our veterans who will need us tomorrow. Please join Disabled American Veterans today and make sure disabled veterans get the benefits they've earned for generations to come. Just $19 a month, only 63 cents a day, helps disabled veterans get the support and services they urgently need right now. Get this patriotic DAV blanket when you call and give just $19 a month as a reminder of the sacrifice our nation's greatest heroes have made for you. There are so many more disabled veterans and their families who still need your support. Please join me in making sure this vital support never stops by calling now or donating at helpdav.org. Thank you, and God bless you.
The Pikes Peak Apex is a multi-day cycling and running event. Heuberger Subaru has been here since the very beginning. When we founded the event in 2020, they were right there as a founding level partner. They also understand, like us, that we've got this amazing network of trails here in the Pikes Peak region. Building more trails for more people and maintaining those trails throughout the year is really important to them as it is us. And that's really kind of in line with what we're doing with the Pikes Peak Apex. We want to get out on those trails and create adventures.
Air Force making it look easy. They're just gliding right along. 28-0 over Robert Morris. You're watching Halftime here at Falcon Stadium, and I am pleased to be joined now by former Falcons quarterback Rob Perez. You played in the early 90s.
Yes, sir.
You played against the likes of Ohio State.
We did.
And you played well. In fact, Ted Sedquist calls you one of the GOATs here. Is that accurate?
He's being very kind. But, yes, we had a good run our junior and senior year, won two bowl games, and had a great experience.
Can you explain how tough it is to learn that quarterback position in this offense? For Zach Lariat to come in and do what he's done so far in this game, you have to be impressed.
I've been very impressed by him today. He's his poise, his command of the offense, and the way he's run the ball and just taking the team up and down the field has been amazing. He's done a great job.
How much has the offense changed from a quarterback's viewpoint since you played the game?
Well, the whole game's changed. You know, kids are bigger, faster, stronger than we were back in the day. But, you know, they do a really good job of executing and competing. And the game's just a little bit faster. But everyone's, you know, catching up and is faster as well.
So if I gave you a few reps in the fourth quarter, would you be able to pick it up like you never left?
Maybe one play.
Your son is a member of the team.
He
Rick
is.
Perez.
Yes, sir.
Was it always in the cards for him to attend the academy?
Actually, no, it wasn't. He was Rip's kind of his own guy, and he wasn't sure he wanted to do it. And then he realized it was he came out and saw the facilities, met some of the players, and what he fell in love with was the coaching staff and the people.
Rob, they may need you in the fourth. You never know. Robert Morris may need you at this point. It's 28-0. Thanks, my friend. I appreciate a few minutes.
Appreciate
Rob
it.
Perez. When we come back, quick look at the first half numbers. The one that counts is right there. It's 28-0.
Tree Farm's 50 cent tree sale. 6 foot tall shade trees. Now get two for only $200.
You take I-25 to exit 235. Then 5 miles west to the tree farm.
The Denver Nuggets are NBA champions. Gear up with the official locker room collection. Available now at NBAstore.com. Get your commemorative NBA Finals men's, women's, and kids championship t-shirts and the official hat. The same ones the players wear as they hoist the Larry O'Brien championship trophy. Plus other unique one-of-a-kind designs. Don't miss out. Shop now. NBAstore.com, a Fanatics experience.
The future of business banking technology. First Bank presents Sarah.
It's just Sarah.
Available in black suit, blue suit, and casual Fridays.
Yay, Fridays.
Features include human interaction, empathy, and actually caring about your business.
The technology you need, the humans you want.
Oh, hi.
First Bank. Business banking for good.
Lock in your spot to watch Mile High Basketball in person next season. 2023-24 season memberships are selling fast. Visit Nuggets.com to place your deposit now.
We all know what it's like to feel alone. But it just takes one new connection.
Want to get out of here?
To empower many.
This is unbelievable.
It doesn't take a superhero to bring forces together. We all have the power to reach out.
Let's go!
And help someone feel like they belong.
Pretty cool, huh?
We are stronger together.
Hey, Mom. I can't wait to tell you about today. I met a new friend. It's great to meet someone who really understands. She lost her dad last year. I really miss you, Mom.
TAPS, the Tragedy Assistance Program for Survivors, provides resources, support, and comfort to heal the hearts and meet the needs of grieving military families. Help us at taps.org/family.
Welcome back to Falcon Stadium, where the Cadets enjoy a 28-0 cushion here over Robert Morris. Air Force undefeated against FCS schools, and it looks no different today. Look at the numbers. They tell the story. You knew Air Force was going to win the rushing game. They are the leading team running the ball in college football, 26 weeks in running all of last season. 176 yards on the ground in this game. They also lead in the passing department, though. Zach Larrier, 95 yards throwing the ball. First Bank highlights. Brought to you by First Bank, member FDIC. Zach Larrier by ground and by air. He ran it 13 times for 90 yards. This one right up the middle for a first down. He also threw the ball three times, 2 of 3 from the pocket for 95 yards. He'll keep this one on the ground. He did a little bit of everything, debuting as a starting quarterback. His first start at the Academy looks good as the Falcons lead 28-0 at the half. Third quarter coming up from the stadium. Taking a break here on Altitude TV. You're watching Air Force football.
Pikes Peak Apex is a multi-day cycling and running event. Kubrick or Subaru has been here since the very beginning. When we founded the event in 2020, they were right there as a founding level partner. They also understand, like us, that we've got this amazing network of trails here in the Pikes Peak region. Building more trails for more people and maintaining those trails throughout the year is really important to them as it is us. And that's really kind of in line with what we're doing with the Pikes Peak Apex. We want to get out on those trails and create adventures.
Did you know that 75% of all aluminum ever produced is still in use today? Which means every time you recycle Ball aluminum packaging, it gets to come back. For every summer barbecue, for every homecoming celebration, and for all the great moments to come. So choose aluminum for your favorite beverages. The future is in your hands. Recycle it.
Let's be real. You don't need to leave the house to have a tasty Italian meal. That's why I partnered with Home Chef. With Home Chef, get easy recipes and fresh ingredients delivered to your door. These tasty meals are from my heart to your kitchen. How good is that? Let's get cooking.
Home Chef. Delicious. Meat simple. Get 18 free meals when you sign up at homechef.com.
Toyota's national sales event is on. Make the most of summer with a new Toyota.
We want the Great Tacoma.
Great Tacoma coming in hot.
On it.
Highlander Hybrid.
Highlander Hybrid on the double hang.
Here we go.
That Red Rav 4.
Run a Red Rav 4.
Hit the deck.
Now that's how you holler.
Right now, lease a 2023 4Runner for $489 per month. Plus, every new Toyota comes with Toyota Care, our no-cost maintenance plan.
Come in today.
Toyota. Let's go places.
At King Soopers, the proven quality of Kroger brand products will make you feel like you're winning. And at lower than low prices, you'll save at checkout too. Kroger brand products, guaranteed you'll love the taste or we'll give you your money back. Now that's winning. King Soopers, fresh for everyone.
Air Force football is brought to you by Intermountain Health, helping people live the healthiest lives possible. By Holman, driving what's right. And by King Soopers, fresh for everyone. As the cadets make their way back to their seats for the second half, let's go downstairs to Katie Wingy.
All right, Vic, this is something that you actually noticed when we were at practice on Wednesday, and the Air Force Falcons already putting up 28 points in that first half. Their offense is running like a well-oiled machine. How do they make things a little bit more difficult on themselves? Well, they use a nylon over the football throughout practice, at least one drill of practice, to really make things hard. It's harder to operate, it's harder to execute. So that way, when they have a regular football without the skin on it, their offense can fly. They can run really, really well. Those throwbacks, those pitchbacks that we see so often that Air Force utilizes, they know that they can do it because they've executed at a very high level. Another note, too, on Saturdays when Coach Calhoun knows that rain might be in the forecast, he'll get the balls wet at practice so that those guys know what it's going to feel like during the game.
I know one thing, Troy Calhoun does not tolerate fumbles in this offense. That could put a stop to any series. And in this game, they've only fumbled it once, a muff punt recovered by Air Force. Other than that, it's been a clean half for the Falcons. They lead 28-0. Bernard Clark lost his starting quarterback earlier in the game as Tyler Sikowski went down with a knee injury. You see the crutches and the bag on his left knee. He was replaced by Anthony Chicken. So quarterback change for Robert Morris. Don't know the status of Zokowski. I just know he's not returning to this game today. Air Force deferred the opening kick, so they will receive here to start the third quarter. Two back for the Falcons. Opening kick of the third quarter. Air Force leads it 28-0, and they're going to down this one in the end zone to start at their own 25. Our Chevy drive of the half brought to you by Chevy. Visit your local Colorado Chevy dealers. It was the long pass play. Zach Larrier to Jared Rosenos for 84 yards. Two plays. That's all it took. They found the back of the end zone, and that's one of four touchdowns so far in this game for the Academy. Second half, same look. Zach Larrier starts at quarterback. Jet Harris, aptly named, in the backfield at fullback. They'll go up the middle with this one to John Lee Eldridge, who's got nowhere to run. Great stick there by Noah Steverson, defensive tackle for Robert Moe. Second and eight now for the Academy as Bernard Clark, former linebacker himself, again, he won a pair of national titles at the University of Miami in the late 80s. So he knows his defense. But how do you defend this? The three-pronged backfield for the Academy. Larrier, pitch. John Lee Eldridge takes the corner, and Eldridge is still on his feet. He'll cut across field. John Lee, will he get there? No, he won't. Stopped at the seven, but pump the brakes. We got a flag way back at the 50. He was brought down by Gregory Young after a 66-yard run by John Lee Eldridge. Let's see what the referees tell us here. They're marching back. We'll get the official call. flag on the field, which would erase a long game. But Air Force is now staying on that side of the field, so this looks like it's against Robert Morris.
Personal foul, illegal block below the waist, number 9, defense. Penalties enforced half the distance to the goal from the end of the run, automatic, first down.
This is the second time we've seen this in this game. Watch number 9 here, Shakespeare Lewis. You're not allowed to go down. You're not allowed to cut like that. Even if you're on the defensive side, we're out there, Shakespeare. He's down on the ground. They throw the flag, and it still results in a 66-yard rumble for John Lee. Here comes now first down inside the 5. Zach Larrier, one back behind him. Larrier will keep up the middle. He puts his head down. Does he cross the plane? They're signaling touchdown, and it is. 6 more for the Falcons, and Zach Larrier, the second effort, gets him in the zone. And now you got to wonder how much work they're going to get that starting offense. It is 34, about to be 35-0. If Matthew DePore can finish it off with the point after. The Air Force offense in mid-season form. DePore makes it a 35-0 ball game early in the third. It took less than a minute to strike. Larrier kept his feet, showed some muscle, and took 3 players across the goal line. Robert Morris down by 35 points here at Falcon Stadium. And she's got a lot of push-ups in store. Here we go. Come on, Katie, come on. That's not even a push-up. Come on.
You're so fast.
I mean, you might as well just stand in place at this point.
Vic, why don't you do some push-ups up there?
I can't lose my breath. I have to talk the game. By the way, 105 push-ups are required at this juncture. That's how many you've done so far.
I need a water break. I need a water break. The funny thing is they don't even notice. Like, I'm just in the background trying to keep up, and they're just hustling over, sprinting in, sprinting out. It's very impressive.
Well, they're not done yet. Tell them to sprint right back. It's 35-0, and I don't think.
I think it's higher here. I think it's higher here. Actually.
Well, it is actually. It's 6,200 feet. We're above sea level considerably.
I actually vote. Do you have a camera up there?
Yes.
You need to do the next round. Zero reason why you shouldn't do it. Yeah.
I have no issues. I'll
okay.
Do the next
you do the next round.
I'll pick it up.
Okay. Perfect.
I got you.
I appreciate that.
That last drive, 3 plays, 75 yards. It only took a minute off the clock. For Zach Larrier plunged in from 4 yards, and here comes Robert Morris, Bobby Moy, trying to give it another shot on the offensive side. We're at that point in the game where I start delivering Robert Morris trivia. The great Robert Morris, one of the founding fathers of our country, not only the signer of the Declaration of Independence and the U.S. Constitution, one of only 6 to sign both, also helped found the U.S. financial system, in case you're wondering. And if you go to the Alexander Hamilton play, he made Alexander Hamilton. He gave him that job. And that'll do it for Robert Morris trivia as they begin their first drive of the second half. Anthony Chickett's going to hand it up off the middle, and then that's not going to do much. Air Force defense too strong up front. So no gain on the play, sets up a 2nd and 10. See what Bernard Clark dials up here. Lost his starting quarterback, Tyler Zukowski, in the 2nd quarter to an injury. Anthony Chickett, who played 4 games last season for the Colonials, he's in a QB now. 6'2", redshirt junior, looks one way, throws the other. Quick screen to his receiver. Oh my goodness, what a pop, and he's still on his feet. Trey Taylor knocking heads out there. Give him credit though, did not go down right away. Net result, nothing, no gain on the play. I heard that helmet from the press box. Chickett throws it wide to Noah Robinson. And Noah Robinson, I would like to introduce you to Trey Taylor. That sets up a third and 10. So no room for that Robert Morris offense to roam. Not in this game. Whistles on the field. Looks like we have a delay of action
for a further review for potential targeting.
Oh, actually, they're going to review this for targeting. Potential targeting. I got to take another look at that. Because you know what happens if you get hit for targeting in college football. You're kicked out of the game. And that would not be a good loss for our Air Force. Not only this game, I believe he missed the first half of the next. Trey Taylor's going to look at the big screen here. Let's take another look. Taylor against Noah Robinson. Was that a helmet to helmet? Was that a target? Clearly a subjective call that the referees are going to decipher right now. Bang, there's the hit. The ball carrier was already in the grasp of one Falcon defender at the time, Jerome Galliard. Trey Taylor came in to finish the job. We'll see what they call in the booth here. Referee.
After review, there is no foul for targeting.
Head official gives us. Jury says no target. Trey Taylor stays in the game, but he's having a talking to right now. It cannot be easy for a defender in this day and age. You're trying to make a tackle, a guy lowers his helmet. They're going to look at all of them, though. We're going to third and 10. Third and 10 from the 25 now for Robert Morris. Anthony Chickett. One in the backfield. He'll go airborne. Chickett steps up in the pocket, keeps it on the ground, loses the football. Jonathan Youngblood popped it out, and in the process, Robert Morris recovers for a first down. There's one way to get a first down. Luke Beltavsky. Boy, there's an offensive lineman's name for you. Beltavsky from Cleveland, Ohio. Watch him. There's the football, and there's Beltavsky, who rumbles another 3 yards across the plane. So first down, and moving the chains is Robert Morris. Put that in the playbook. Anthony Chickett doesn't like what he sees, and Robert Morris is going to call a timeout. Early third quarter here at Falcon Stadium.
Charged him out of the half. Robert Morris, media timeout.
That's us. That's the media. That means we're taking a break. Air Force up 35-0.
Help us in supporting over 1,000 cadet athletes at the United States Air Force Academy. Join the Falcon Athletic Fund today and be responsible for funding critical projects and providing the margin of excellence resources necessary for our cadet athletes to compete for championships at the highest level.
A chance to win a trip to see your favorite pro football team play with 5-Hour Energy's Ultimate Fan Football Sweepstakes. Plus, you'll unlock a 20% off code for team merch at fanatics.com. Whoa! Enter today.
The Tree Farm's 50 cent tree sale. 7 to 8 foot tall flowering trees now get 2 for $2.70.
You take I-25 to exit 235.
then 5 miles west to the tree farm.
Oh, they're having a good time today. It's 35 zip here at the United States Air Force Academy. And the cadets are having a good time. When you're up 35-0 against anybody, you're always having a good time. Ted, what have you seen so far in the second half?
Well, in the second half, I saw Air Force come out and not be complacent. I mean, they've still played with that high energy and vigor that you need and have attacked this Colonial offense on the defensive side.
Oh, Anthony Chicken had a receiver, and it is incomplete. Noah Robinson could not haul it in. Chicken, in my opinion, has given them a little life.
Yeah, he really has. I mean, he's got certainly a better set of feet, the ability to scramble and to move around right there. He's moving to his left, throwing with his right.
Again, some would call this adversity, but this is a kid who overcame Hodgkin's lymphoma. Anthony Chicken did, not once, but twice. So there's no such thing as football adversity when you've done that. Second and 10 for Chicken and the Colonials. Fakes the pitch, throws the quick one that looked to go to the sideline, but it falls incomplete. Parker Fetterman wanted to get to it, but could not. Sets up another third down for Robert Morris. They converted their last third down the most creative way possible by a fumble recovery by their center, which seems to work. They're one for one on that play.
Yeah, that's going to be a hard one to draw up again.
Let's see what Josh Firm, the OC, draws up on this one. Third and 10 from the 35, down 35. Chicken in shotgun. Robinson in motion. Chicken, quick slant, complete, and the chains keep moving for Robert Morris. Great little swing pass, number 12. That's 12 yards, I should say, on the reception. They made it look easy there. Andre Cooper with the catch.
Yeah, nice adjustment right here. Ball a little bit behind him, and he's able to adjust that body on the fly, catch the ball, and then turn it up, convert the first down.
A new assortment of receivers for Robert Morris. Only one guy, Parker Fetterman, returns from last year's offense on the receiving core. First down. Chickett's going to keep it in the air. Another swing pass. This one to his running back. Day-Day Jones could not find any daylight there. Stopped by Jalen Murgerson. Chicken so far in this game, again, he's given him some life. 7 of 9 from the pocket for 37 yards.
Yeah, not doing what they don't want him to do, which is force the football downfield. And most of the time this is the case, these Colonial receivers are covered by the Air Force defenders. He's dumping it out to his running backs and then letting them just get up the field and get what they can.
Just a chip away offense. Keep chipping away best you can. Chicken fakes the handoff and throws a dart to the Air Force 35, a gain of 14.
Outstanding release of the football right there. He comes off the play action. Watch him right here, come off the play action, make the read, and boom, the ball's out of his hands. Puts it out there in front of the receiver, and he's able to catch it.
Chase Jackson on the receiving end. Anthony Chicken has got it going on so far in this second half. Again, Chicken played in 4 games last year, so he's seen experience. He's had plenty of experience in this offense. This time, the reverse pass. Chicken, wide open. O'Sullivan, touchdown. Wow, come on, O'Sullivan. But uh-oh, flags flying in the end zone on the line of scrimmage. We've got an Air Force player injured in the backfield. We've got Robert Morris players with hands on knees. They know this one's coming back. Gamby Goff is in severe pain right now near midfield. We'll see what the call is, but it looks like this one's coming back. This might be another one, the hit below the knee call that we've seen twice in this game so far, Ted.
Yeah, again.
Can't cut block, can't do it.
There are two fouls in the play, both by the offense. An eligible receiver downfield, number 73. It's a 5-yard penalty from the previous spot. After the play was over, unsportsmanlike conduct, number 4, offense. That 15-yard penalty is enforced in the succeeding spot. We'll replay first down. That is number 4's first unsportsmanlike conduct foul of the game.
All right, the unsportsmanlike product of Kamana Sullivan celebrating in the end zone. The injury to Gamby Goff had nothing to do with those penalties. As we look at the replay here, a little double reverse quarterback flea flicker action. Wide open as O'Sullivan has to go over the other shoulder. Let's see what he does to warrant that. He spins the ball in the end zone. I guess that's an unsportsmanlike these days, unless he said something. So that's your unsportsmanlike, and then he dances a bit. Didn't you ever dance and spin the ball in the end zone when you scored, Ted?
Well, when I did score, I usually look for the guy that made the block for me, go give him a big hug.
Well, that's the bigger story for Air Force is Gamby Goff, the senior spur. He plays that spur position. Can you explain what the spur position is in this defense?
Well, similar to a situation where if you've got a nickel defense and we say the nickel back, it's that spur, that fifth defensive back that comes in.
In other words, he's very versatile. 3-year starter on this defense, and to lose him looked like his left leg. We'll get an update on that a little bit later. But Robert Morris maintained possession, but it's first and 30 now. More flags.
False start, number 27, offense, 5-yard penalty. Still
how many flags for Robert Morris in this game? It has been truly a laundry list for the Colonials, and it's hurting them immensely. Now first and 35. Seventh penalty of the game, Chicken. Quick pass out of the backfield to his running back. Pushed out of bounds. Alec Mock with the defense there. Quick game. They're being a lot more conservative with their passing game, and it seems to be doing something.
Yeah, Air Force with first and 35, they're going to drop as deep as they possibly can, just not give up the big play. And these swing passes are open all day long. Might as well, if your Chicken, work on that ability to get rid of the football out into the flat and then let your running back or the receiver try to take the ball upfield and get as much as he possibly can.
Second and 30, Chickett stands in the pocket, stands no more. Too much heat. James Tomasi right up the gut along with Bo Richter. And Chickett goes down for a loss. Second sack of the game for the Air Force Falcons. That's a loss of 8 now, and it sets up the always lovely third and 37. How many plays in the playbook for this?
Not very many, for sure. And not that there's a play that can that hold off that defensive front for that long to go that deep.
Here's Chicken. Dump it off over the middle. Just trying to grab a chunk of yardage there to give them reasonable field position. Nowhere close to the first down, and they'll have to punt on fourth. Terrell Ridgely with the catch there. Fourth and 30. Not sure why they're talking to the sideline, but penalty again. This one's declined, thankfully. Seven penalties, that's number 8. This one's declined on Robert Morris in this game. How much of that is nerves and how much of that is the first game with a bunch of transfers?
I think it's both, to be quite honest with you. You know, to come out here to play at this altitude, you're probably tired. You're down 35 points. You're trying to make things happen.
And George Souders back to punt. Sixth year of football. Changes it up a little bit, this little rugby style action. His first couple of punts were, oh, it's muffed. For the second time in this game, Air Force muffs a punt, and Souders goes down to congratulate his special teams unit. Joe Malcheski hustles down to recover the muffed punt. Cade Harris, first time he got some help from one of his teammates, but this time no teammate to be found, and Robert Morris is back in business.
Yeah, again, Harris is going to have to learn, you know, when to let that ball just go, and then if he does decide to catch it, he's going to have to come up and secure it. Both times, this ball, tremendous amount of backspin on it. You saw the punter sprint to his right. And then the last one was kind of a knuckleball line drive.
That's why they throw that rugby-style approach to it. Just change the spin on the football, and it worked wonders for Robert Moe on that play. Here comes first down in Air Force territory for the first time today. Chickett's going to hand it off. Cyrus Bonsu, the transfer out of the University of Massachusetts with the carry. He's good for five.
Yep, nice leg drive there on contact. Kept it going, was able to pick up an extra 2 yards after that first contact. Air Force backed up really for the first time today.
Just outside the 10-yard line for Robert Morris. Again, nowhere close to scoring in this game. This is the best opportunity they've had. Chickett. Hands it off. They'll go up the middle. Another good gainer. 5 more yards. Keep moving the chains. That's exactly what they want to do at this point. Good little run up the gut. Brought down, and that sets up a first and goal for Bobby Moe.
Excellent job on the left side of that offensive line, washing down the Air Force defensive end and then moving on the linebacker level. Puts him in, like you said, first down and goal to go.
Bonsu takes the handoff. Cyrus Bonsu throws his head in there, spins, approaches the end zone, but it looks like Jonathan Youngblood tackles him down before he gets there. If you want to see the difference between a first and second half and the quarterback change and what it's done for Robert Morris, first half, they generated 53 yards of offense. Just this quarter alone, they're at 59, Ted.
Yeah, outstanding job. Obviously, a tremendous amount of respect for the quarterback here and what he means to this team as a leader.
But Anthony Chickett giving them a little pep in the step. It's second and goal. Bonsu back up the middle. Can he bounce in? Bonsu fumbles the ball at the goal line, but he's down first. Referee says he's down. Goodness. And be down at the half yard line. Bonsu, the UMass transfer, carrying it hard. Take a look at the replay, Ted. What do you see?
You know, outstanding job by that left side of the Air Force defensive line, and definitely that ball was knocked out of there at the goal line.
They're going to review it. They are certainly going to review this one.
The previous play is
too close
to call.
Question is, and you could not tell from the angle we showed you, couldn't tell if his knee was down. He's stretching for the plane of the end zone, the plane of the goal line, but I don't know if the knee was down before he lost that football. Take another look here. Maybe this will show it to us. Left knee. It looks like he's down.
Yeah, it does. It looks like he went down before the ball popped out of there. But great job by the Air Force defender knocking that ball out, giving his teammates an opportunity to try to create a turnover deep in their own territory. You know, believe it or not, these are the types of situations that you hope come up in this
in these kind of games. Yeah.
In these kind of games, because these are lessons that they'll learn and be able to take on, you know, with Sam Houston State next week down in Houston, and then the following week coming back and playing Utah State.
That's a good point. When you're playing Utah State, who has had Air Force's number over the last couple of years, by the way, and it's a third and goal situation, you pin your hopes on what you've done in games like this.
You're exactly right. And these are opportunities that you just can't recreate, really, I think, in practice to the level that you get in making the same reactions and the lessons that you learn in a game type situation.
By the way, interesting schedule for the Falcons this season. They will play in five different time zones: East Coast, Central, Mountain, of course the Pacific, and then they're in Hawaii too.
Oh, goodness gracious. In 1980, we traveled over 25,000 miles in a 12-game schedule. And I didn't think anything could match that, but these guys are going to come close to it.
Well, they talk so much about conference realignment, and currently the Mountain West is as is. But if there's ever a team that can play nationally, Air Force is a national brand.
No doubt. And I think being part of a member of a conference out here in the West has been good for Academy football over the last 40-something years since we joined the WAC back in 1980. But at the same time, you know, I know the kids and I know the program and those that follow Air Force football. They want the spotlight and the notoriety. And I think with the brand of football that we play, given the opportunity to play anyone, you've got a shot of winning. Now, what ultimately happens if you're in an SEC or a bigger conference like that, it'll wear the kids down. You know, playing these bigger, faster clubs with the talent that they got, as deep as they are, it just wears you out.
After review, the ruling on the field stands. Third down.
That took a little longer than expected. Obviously, they saw what we saw. The knee hit the ground, so no fumble. Sets up a third and inches. Third and inches. Four down territory. I could see four down territory for Bobby Moe, but let's see what they do here on third. Air Force awaiting the snap. Quarterback keeper with Chickett. Does he get enough penetration? No signal from the official. We got fourth down.
Robert Moore lined up in the I formation and then just tried to sneak it in with the fullback coming in from behind and trying to push him over. Watch him here on the replay. But great job inside by the Falcons, stacking that offensive line, actually pushing back. I think they lost some yards.
I think they did too. Chickett lucky to hold on to that football. He had Falcons all over him. Fourth down. They're going to kick. They want points. They don't want to leave here shut out. They're going for the points. Jason Jenkins.
Charge him out of the half. Robert Morris, 30 seconds.
Another quick timeout to talk this one over. Do you think he's getting a say? He's second guessing his decision here, or?
Well, I'll be honest with you. If I were Coach Clark, I'd take the points. It's an opportunity again to practice the snap, the hold, the kick, to put your kicker in a pressure type of situation. Down 35 with only about a little bit left in the third and an entire fourth quarter. It's highly unlikely they're going to even have enough possessions to catch up. Why not go ahead and take this opportunity to practice?
Yeah, the scoreboard always looks a little better when you have something other than a zero on it.
No doubt.
But they think otherwise. Here comes Anthony Chicken in the starting offense. They thought it over. 30 seconds later, they're greedy. They want the touchdown. Here we go. Fourth down. Fourth and goal. Down 35 zip. Pride on the line at this point. Chicken. And another Robert Morris penalty.
Number 21.
Goodness gracious. Chase Jackson jumped. That's their eighth penalty of the game. And now the decision is easier for Bernard Clark. You see him move there at the line of scrimmage. They had a big tight end in the backfield. They were going to go to the tight end, Tayshawn Mayfield. Instead, march it back and let's take the kick. That's nine penalties for Robert Morris. As Jason Jenkins looks to get the Colonials on the board for the first time in this game. Not going to happen. Snap through the hands of Souders. Trey Williams picks it up. Not only do they get the touchdown, they don't even get a field goal. They get nothing. It's 35-0 at the Academy. Man, that's a Robert Morris day right there.
depth algorithm, it's almost guaranteed a touchdown every time.
When he compares telemetry to throwing a perfect spiral, it's just incredible.
Right? So we're all having a lot of fun right now, but don't forget it's hustle.
I don't know how he explains rocket science with just X's and O's, but he's good.
Well, he's one of our veterans, so he has a lot of experience.
Does that mean that he was in the military or that he's been with the team a long time?
And they're going to do like a banana.
Yes.
Algorithm, right? Now, I'm no rocket scientist, but actually I am.
Everyone has a community, a neighborhood, school, kids' teams, where you worship, work, work out, or any other place or group where you choose to belong. Communities can provide support when you need it, and even when you don't know you do. Like when it comes to preventing underage drinking and other substance use, community members can be your eyes and ears when you're not with your kids and alert you to signs of potential problems. Learn more at talktheyhearyou.samhsa.gov.
I could stand here and tell you if my prostate cancer wasn't caught early, I might not be alive today.
I could tell you that the cutting-edge research funded by the Prostate Cancer Foundation has helped patients live longer with less complications.
I could tell you all of this, but really, it's up to you.
It's your health.
It's your life.
Go to PCF.org for the help you need to navigate this disease. Go to PCF.org today.
Air Force football brought to you by Ball Corporation. The future is in your hands. Recycle it. And by Brakes Plus, with 48 Colorado locations to serve you. Late third quarter here at the Academy, and we've got a quarterback change for the Falcons. Zach Larrier, prime performance in his starting debut. He gives way to a new quarterback, Jensen Jones, who moves the pile. Jensen Jones, 6'2", 215 out of Naples, Florida. He brings a little beef to the lineup.
Yeah, he does. And they ran that little quarterback keeper where he follows the fullback up into the gap right there. And a nice gain on his first carry of the season.
Gain of 7. Jones back under center. They don't waste any time at Air Force. Back up the middle they go. Good enough for another first down. This time the fullback, Jet Harris. Aptly named. Real name is Carson. But now that he's playing football at the Academy, we're going to go with Jet.
I'm not even sure what to say.
I mean, how perfect is that?
Exactly.
Jet Harris, 6'1", 225 senior. Gray, Tennessee. We've got first down, first and 10 from the 27. Jensen Jones. In at QB, he's going to keep it. He's got room up the middle. Jones breaks one tackle, breaks another near the 40-yard line at about the 39 after a gain of 11. Jamar Chagog rodeos him down there.
Yeah, again, a good feel for that little quarterback counter to the backside.
We've got an injury on the field right now. Another Robert Morris. Looks like somebody's cramping up. That's what going through a little muscle relaxation period in the calf. Let's take a break from the Academy.
The Colorado Avalanche is proud to continue the partnership with the Colorado Amateur Hockey Association. Together, our efforts are to support the growth of the great game of hockey throughout the state of Colorado. Learn more at co.hockey.
The Pikes Peak Apex is a multi-day cycling and running event. Heuberger Subaru has been here since the very beginning. When we founded the event in 2020, they were right there as a founding level partner. They also understand, like us, that we've got this amazing network of trails here in the Pikes Peak region. Building more trails for more people and maintaining those trails throughout the year is really important to them as it is us. And that's really kind of in line with what we're doing with the Pikes Peak Apex. We want to get out on those trails and create adventures.
America, it's time to gear up and get out there in a new Ford vehicle. And it all starts at your local Ford dealer during the Discover Summer Sales Event. Choose from a great selection of trucks and SUVs equipped with the tech and comfort you need to discover your best summer ever. With a large inventory in stock, now is the best time to trade in, trade up, and discover summer with Ford. Now buy or lease a select 2023 Ford SUV and get $1,000 trade assist cash plus financing as low as 0.9. Only at your local Ford stores.
Welcome back to the Academy Air Force. In a romp so far, 35-0, preserving the shutout after that goal line stand on the last series. Jensen Jones now in at quarterback. He spells Zach Larrier, who played superbly for 2.5 quarters. Give him a little break. Larrier finishes the day, 14 carries, 99 yards, 2 TDs. He also threw it 3 times for 95 and a touchdown. This one, back on the ground. Got a burst! And what a burst it is! Wow! Dylan Carson, the sophomore. His first carry of the game goes for 32.
Vic, watch this right here. Tremendous vision. He heads up the middle and sees the cut. There's just a feel. There's a certain feel you have as a fullback right there that you know by how the blocks are going, where the alignment is defensively, where the hole might be. And he had the vision in the field right there to break it for a big gainer.
If not for Jossa Diakiti, that might be housed. First and 10 from the 33. Jensen moving this offense quickly and efficiently. We're going to go up the middle again. Same ball carrier. Why not Dylan Carson for 10 more?
Well, I know these guys are listed on our sheet here as the backups. However, they are hitting the holes, making the decisions as good as that starting group did.
Well, that's what Troy Calhoun told us before this game. He's experimenting here. He's got a collection of quarterbacks, of fullbacks, of receivers. I mean, think about who they lost last year. Zeke Daniels gone. Brad Roberts gone. Their two top receivers gone.
You're exactly right. And these guys didn't get a whole lot of opportunities. So you've got a chance now to feel out who.
Jensen Jones keeps it. Oh, the ball popped loose. But he was down first. The referee indicates down before they strip it. Take another look, just in case. Grinding for extra yards. Yeah, legs are down. 8-yard carry there for Jensen Jones. By the way, Air Force already in this game. 309 yards rushing. There's Carson again. Chains keep moving as we count down the end of the third quarter. And the Air Force Falcons are looking for more. They're up 35-0 after three. It's Falcons football on Altitude Sports.
Hi, I'm Ryan Blaney, a third-generation race car driver, and we dedicate a lot of our time to going as fast as possible. My Grandpa Lou is the reason why my dad and I started racing, and I'm really proud to follow in his tracks. But when my grandpa was diagnosed with Alzheimer's, it was a very unexpected bump in the road for us. I've learned a lot on this journey with my Grandpa Lou, and the memories of my grandpa will always be with me. And in our family, we're used to getting involved, and I encourage you to do the same, especially when it comes to caring for your loved ones. When I think about Alzheimer's and the impact it had on my family, I recognize that losing a race isn't such a bad day after all. It's important to notice if older family members are acting differently, experiencing problems with their memory, or having trouble with routine tasks. Talking about Alzheimer's can be really tough, but if you notice something, have a conversation with your loved one. encourage them to see a doctor, or offer to go with them. Early detection of Alzheimer's can give your family time to explore support services, make a plan for the future, and access available treatments. If you or your family are noticing changes, it could be Alzheimer's. Talk about seeing a doctor together.
All right, if you're back at home, put up all four fingers. It's the fourth quarter here at the Academy with the Falcons leading Robert Morris 35-0 and driving for more. Jensen Jones in at quarterback. First and 10 from the 11. Jed Harris lined up behind him. They're going to hand it off. And this one's good for about three more. A little off-tackle action to Cameron Breyer.
You know, Vic, I know the fans, they tend to look at a game like this and think, well, why don't you just load up the buses and go home? But there's a lot of valuable play time right now being picked up by players that normally aren't going to see the field, and opportunities that that you can only get on game day.
Jensen's going to keep it. Shoestring tackle there by Garrett Fairman. I could have prevented a touchdown because there was a lot of room in front of Jensen Jones. And now we move to 3rd and 7. Air Force 5 of 6 on third downs today. They've been very efficient in this portion of the field. Let's see what they dial up with the new quarterback, new fullback. They brought in a lot of second team linemen, I've noticed as well. So they've gone second unit in this second half. Jones fakes, runs, looks for that goal line. Look at Jensen Jones move those feet. Wow. He got some help along the way. Wesley Ndego with the initial gap, but he just, Jed Harris, watch Jed Harris from behind. Hop on.
Now carried him into the end zone himself. Look at those feet keep moving on contact. There's 1, 2, 3 Colonials in there. Great second effort.
I love it when the big fellas do that. Let me just grab you, put you in my back pocket and get to the goal line. Don't you worry about it. Here comes the point after, which is good. And we got a good old-fashioned route. 42-0 Air Force at the United States Air Force Academy.
Over nearly a century, Holman has evolved into the world's largest integrated automotive services company. Our unique range of services enable us to provide our customers with exceptional experiences. From buying, to leasing, to servicing, selling, and so much more, we've got the expertise, the resources, and the dedication to meet your every automotive need. Here's to another 100 years of driving what's right.
Hi, I'm Jake Jabs. American Furniture Factories are knitting business. They're shipping fast with great buys like this beautiful new sectional from Fusion. We have lots of new chairs for $188 or less. Lots of recliners at $298 or less. Lots of home offices at great prices, and lots of bedroom and dining room sets all in stock. And because of our buying power, our prices are going down, not up.
The new East Club will provide Falcon Stadium with a new and unparalleled setting to take in Air Force football. Reserve your tickets to the new club and experience end-zone-to-end-zone viewing, premium bars, concessions, and 2 exclusive viewing decks every game day. For more, visit falconathleticfund.com.
Well, a whole lot of push-ups today if you're a cadet. You total them up. They do push-ups for every point after every score. It's 42-0. That's a grand total of 147 push-ups. I'm not going to do that many because I don't like to show off, but I will raise the roof. I will raise the roof 147 times. Will that do, Katie?
No, that's completely unacceptable. At least, like, lean against the wall and do that version of
it. One-handed raising of the roof. One-handed raising of the roof. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm almost there.
You can't be up there talking about my push-up form and then do raise the roof as your form of a push-up. I won't accept it.
Well, I don't like this either. This is a nice little run back for Robert Morris as they get back 45-yard kick return. Robert Carter Jr., take a look at a replay here. You know when they look back at this tape, Ted, coaches aren't going to like this. Any special teams breakdowns?
No, not at all. And there have been a couple of times today where I thought the Colonials in their return game had an opportunity to get to that edge. But right there, you can see they were able to seal it off. And Carter Jr.'s got some speed.
He does. Anthony Chickett back for more at quarterback. They came close on the last series. Let's see what they can do here. They keep chipping away with those short passes. Here's another one, good for 8.
A little quick out right there. Nice timing again. Chickett gets rid of the ball quickly.
Gets it to Chase Jackson. They cross midfield for only the third time in this game, Ted.
Wow.
And Anthony Chickett, we talked about some of the spunk he has brought to the Colonials offense. He's 11 of 13 for 71 yards in this game. Second and 2. Chickett will keep. Now he'll throw. Goes outside to his running back, and that's good enough for a first down. Very well played by Anthony Chickett.
Yeah, no doubt. Chickett brings a mobility to the position that just you didn't see before with the other quarterback. You can pronounce his name.
Zelkowski. Yes. That's actually a quick toss to his tight end, Landon Lucas. Transfer from a JUCO in California, Fresno City. Next play is also a nice little pop. 5-yard gainer. Robert Morris got it going on right now. Patrick Dolan with the stop. Not until he got that ball to the 32-yard line. Sets up 2nd and 4. Falcons going with reserves on defense. This one sidearm. Got some room, lots of room, but out at the 2-yard line. A touchdown saving tackle by the Academy there. Or that's 6th, a 30-yard gain, if not for Jake Smith, who came across the field to knock Noah Robinson out of bounds. That's first points on the board for Robert Morris.
Yeah, excellent execution right there, the outside screen. You saw them let the interior of the Falcon defense come up underneath, and those linemen got out to their right rather quickly, set up a great wall, scoring position.
First and goal from the 2. They've been here before. Chickett up the middle. Nowhere to go. Kamon O'Sullivan stopped and popped. Maybe a gain of a half yard, if that.
Again, Air Force defense done a great job down here around the goal line with inside penetration by those big defensive linemen. And then the linebackers coming in to fill it and finish.
Levi Brown making that last stop. A lot of reserves in for the Falcons defense as well, up 42-0. 2nd and goal. Movement up front there for Robert Morris. Chickett takes the snap. He'll roll left, quick pass. He's got a man. And Bobby Moe gets on the board, ladies and gentlemen. Nice little toss to Chase Jackson for 6. Chickett to Jackson.
Yeah, they got to feel really good. They being the Robert Morris coaching staff of what Chickett's brought to this offensive unit. And the biggest thing is confidence. You can tell he plays like he's been out there before.
Again, the story last year, Anthony Chickett started the season for Robert Morris, got hurt after 4 games. Today, he was a backup, came into the game when Zukowski got hurt, and boy, he has provided them a shot of energy, much needed. Robert Morris will not go home shut out. They score 7. It's 42-7 here at Falcon Stadium.
Help us in supporting over 1,000 cadet athletes at the United States Air Force Academy. Join the Falcon Athletic Fund today and be responsible for funding critical projects and providing the margin of excellence resources necessary for our cadet athletes to compete for championships at the highest level.
The Colorado Avalanche is proud to continue the partnership with the Colorado Amateur Hockey Association. Together, our efforts are to support the growth of the great game of hockey throughout the state of Colorado. Learn more at co.hockey.
Home cooks, start your ovens. It's time to get dinner ready faster. With Home Chef's easy prep and no-mess options, you're winning dinner when you cook with Home Chef. Get oven-ready meals done in 3, 2, 1. It's time to set the table and go eat. Delicious meets simple. Get 18 free meals at homechef.com.
Air Force football brought to you by Starry, proud partner of Air Force Academy football, and by Chevy. Visit your local Colorado Chevy dealers today. 10:35 remaining in this game. Air Force leading comfortably 42-7. But I tell you what, Anthony Chickett made it look easy on the last drive for Robert Morris. Six plays, 56 yards, just under 3 minutes off the clock. He's your starting quarterback for Bobby Moe.
Yeah, no doubt. I'd have him right in there next week against St. Francis and from the get-go all week long, take all the snaps with the number one offense.
Again, Tyler Zukowski came into the game as a starter. He's the transfer from Albany, but hurt his knee in the second quarter, and Chickett has been money ever since. Kickoff here for Robert Morris, fielded at the 10. And it'll be taken to about the 25-yard line. Back downstairs to Katie Wingy. Katie?
All right, I have the Air Power Legacy Series helmet right here. And this will debut October 21st when Air Force takes on Navy. It's really sweet. There's a lot of stories to this, so I want to try and show you quite a few of them. We've got the B-25 right there on the front talking about the planes that were involved. This crest right here will be on the uniforms. My hands full. This is kind of hard to rotate around. On the back of the helmet, they'll have the nickname of some of the planes that were involved. And then right there, you have a picture of the bombers. And this will be honoring the Doolittle Raiders. And that was something that was launched, that raid was launched. And Ted, you could probably talk about this much better than I, Vic, you history major. These are a lot of details that I'm just learning for the first time, but they launched this Doolittle raid April 18th, 1942 in response to the attack on Pearl Harbor. So these uniforms will be honoring that raid and the planes and the pilots that were involved in that. Pretty cool. They're very reflective. I'm excited to see how the full uniform comes together.
Thank you, Katie. And as you well know, Ted Sundquist, the players love wearing that fresh gear. They love it.
There's no doubt, and the great thing about it, especially with the NCAA kind of lightening up the rules a little bit with regards to alternate uniforms, is we've been able, through this legacy series over the years, to honor folks like the Thunderbirds and the F-4s that flew in Vietnam and a number of other things. It's just a great platform to bring the history of air power to the Air Force football.
Well said. Look good, feel good, feel good, play good. Another quarterback change for the Academy. Ben Britton, another senior, takes his crack at the QB spot. And Britton pop off about 8 yards on that carry. Tizlan Muhammad with the tackle. Coach Calhoun told us before the game, hey, they've got three quarterbacks. They're unsure which one they'll go with, but safe to say Zach Larrier passed the test in his first game?
Yeah, I think so. And again, not just from the things that we saw outwardly, but also inwardly. I thought he did a great job of getting the offense set up in the right formation, in the right play, audible when he needed to. Great leadership out there on the field.
Second and three. Why not continue to run it up the gut if you keep moving the chains? Air Force now 356 yards rushing. Last season, they had 300-yard-plus games in six of them. Six times they eclipsed 300 yards. They've done it today. They did it. Heck, they did it in the third quarter today.
Well, they're not. This coaching staff, and especially on that offensive side with Mike Thiessen helping call the plays and Troy Calhoun and his offensive background, they're not hard-headed. You know, if something works, they're going to stick with it. And they've been able over the last 3 years with Zeke Daniels and Brad Roberts to really move the ball on the ground again today.
First down run, Britton keeps, and Britton will keep his head down for about three more. I've been meaning to ask you, with the rule change and the clock continuously running, that's a new quarterback, actually. They're going deep down the roster right now. John Boucher carried the rock on that last one.
Well, these are, again, invaluable reps that you just can't recreate on the practice field on a Wednesday afternoon, Vic. And the opportunity to get in, get some real live action coming at you is just invaluable.
John Boucher, no relation to Bobby Boucher. He'll end this one off tackle, and that churns out seven more, close to a first down. I wanted to ask about the first downs and the new rule this year, where in the past they would stop the clock after every first down. Not anymore, only until the final 2 minutes of each half. Is that an advantage for a ball control offense like Air Force?
Yeah, I think so. I absolutely do. And it allows you to just keep the pressure on, keep the gas down, wear the defense out. And truly, when you talk about control the clock, you're doing just that.
Whistle on the field
ball
looks
start.
Like
number 85. False start. Offense, 5-yard penalty, still third down.
Gonna get that with all these mass substitutions. Number 12 you see in the lineup is John Boucher, new quarterback. He's only a sophomore. Just goes to thinking about Zeke Daniels and what he did in 3 years as a starter. It's not easy getting that position early in your career. He did it for 3 years, never gave it back.
Outstanding job there. You know, let this play go.
That was the delayed run, the delayed quarterback keeper for Boucher, and we're going to get to fourth down.
Well, you know how we were talking early before the game started about how Air Force does a great job of having seniors at most of their positions with experience? It's opportunities like this where they take advantage of playing their young players so that by the time they are the guy their senior year, it's not brand new to them. They've had some opportunities in game-like situations they can fall back on, and they're not total rookies.
You knew that Calhoun would go for it here because he was not happy with the failed fourth down attempt in the first half. Fourth and three, option left, keeper, Boucher pushes the pile easily for a first down. And yes, you can do it indeed.
Watch this on the replay. There's just a subtle move right here at the very end that he forces and makes that defender miss right there, 37. Dips in and then out and runs through the arm tackle.
We have an injured Robert Morris player on the field. Air Force is driving. Looks like Joel Michelski is down there. They're going to look over him when we come back. Fourth quarter, Falcons are rolling.
People are always asking me, why?
Why do I do this work?
Two words come to mind for me. One is responsibility.
the other's purpose.
It's just so inspiring to do research that impacts human lives.
Stand Up to Cancer has been a critical partner in advancing research for cancer.
Cancer research saves lives.
So please help us fight in this battle against cancer.
At the U.S. Center for Safe Sport, we see champions everywhere we look. In every sport, on every court, we're building a foundation to ensure all athletes are safe, supported, and strengthened. At the U.S. Center for Safe Sport, ending abuse is not just our job. It's our promise.
So, Teddy, in our era, flock of seagulls was a big deal. How about a flock of falcons? Is that what you call it technically? What's the technical term?
That's a good question. I think you got me stumped right now. I don't know. Is it a brood? Is it a flock?
A gaggle? Somebody help us out. Joe Michalski limps off for Robert Morris. He was injured on the previous play. Let's hope he's all right. Air Force maintains possession, and that clock keeps ticking now. Under 5 minutes to play and a 42-7 advantage. Sophomore quarterback John Boucher getting some reps here. Falcons emptying the bench using a lot of second and third teamers as expected. They have never lost to an FCS opponent. Multiple Falcons, I'm told, by the way, are called a kettle of Falcons. See, I knew you'd get the answer very quickly. A kettle. Thank you, Patrick Chavez. Cannon Turner gets some run at quarterback now. So he replaces John Boucher. Cannon Turner. That's our fifth quarterback of the afternoon.
Well, they're going deep in the bullpen. This is like letting your entire bullpen get an opportunity to come in and pitch a little bit.
How long before Troy Calhoun straps it up again?
That'll be a while.
Former Air Force quarterback, played in the 80s. The last number nine to start a quarterback for the Falcons before Zach Larrier today. This one's handed off up the middle. And I'm going deep on the roster now. Yeah, you know he wants to run the ball one more time. We all do. He's smiling, though. I mean, reason to smile with a performance like this.
Yeah, I think so. I mean, you know, I looked at some of the keys to the game that I was thinking about. You wanted to sustain long drives. They were able to do that. You don't want to turn the football over. I thought they did a good job of protecting the football today. And pressure, pressure, pressure on the defense.
We've now gone to the Joiner roster on the media sheet here as nice carry off tackle by Cannon Turner. There are a bunch of players that don't even fit on the actual roster, so we have an adjoining roster that we referred to there. And you knew they'd get to that in the fourth quarter at some point. Some of these running backs you'll see come from there. These are guys that won't get much playing time at all this season outside of this game.
Yeah, but with an opportunity to do it on Parents Weekend, with everything that's gone on today and you know, all the visitors that have come out to see this opener against Robert Morris, it's fantastic that the staff has turned and allowed these guys to experience game day for themselves.
Fourth and five, and this play will go backwards. That one doesn't work. Caden Cloud, it's a cloudy day there, and Robert Morris, look at the big fella. Did he get the right jersey when they had those jerseys swapped or not? The right one come up for him? If you missed it, the jerseys got here late, but I want to make sure you got the right one as they switch now. Falcons bring their defense back on the field and last chance with 2:07 to play for Bobby Moe on offense.
Well, you hope on this defensive side with Brian Knorr that he's been able to interchange some of his back end of the roster players, give them an opportunity to get in.
Chickett back to pass. Ooh, right through the hands of his intended target there. Did not work out for Landon Lucas. And that sets up second down.
Again, if I'm Robert Morris and Coach Bernard Clark going back to Pennsylvania. I look at this game, and not totally negative. I know they came out here and they wanted to perform well, and they wanted to win the football game. But there are elements here, like you've said, Vic, throughout this game of Chickett and what he brought to the offense.
He did his job, that's for sure. Second down, Chickett stands in the pocket. He'll go deep. This one over the outstretched arms there of his intended target, James Westring, pulls up, limping off the field a little bit.
There were times defensively that I thought the Colonials did a pretty good job down there in the red zone and in stacking that Air Force front. By and large, you know, it's just going to take time for some of these kids that have transferred into gel and they start playing as a unit. Right now, it feels a little bit like you got 11 guys running around out there trying to do their own thing until Chickett came in and got the offense to gel a little bit.
Chickett, Pittsburgh kid from Bethel Park. He's a revered in that area. A lot of Pittsburgh kids on the roster. Got a sweep right that goes nowhere. Air Force bottles it up. That'll set up a fourth down. Way to protect the edge there as Parker Fetterman gets pushed out of bounds for a loss of three.
And Vic, real quick, you know, I'm sure a lot of Falcon fans are wondering, well, how in the heck did we get Robert Morris on the schedule anyway?
Yeah. How did we get Robert Morris on the schedule anyway?
Well, it's funny you should ask. So Dr. Chris Howard, who was a great running back for this Falcon offense in the late 80s, was president of Robert Morris University up until just about a year or two ago when he's moved to Arizona State. He was able to work with the Air Force administration in the athletic department and get this set up. And certainly I think he wanted an opportunity to get his university on the in the spotlight, come out here west, travel on an airplane, and experience that as a program. Yeah.
And listen, we've talked about these kind of matchups. They happen all over college football, especially early in the season like this. Both programs benefit. Air Force obviously trying to work out the kinks. Robert Morris, first and only game on an airplane. And they get a substantial amount of money that'll help their program moving forward.
Yeah, it's a no-brainer on both sides. And again, an experience that these kids will talk about for the rest of their life. I mean, I'm here right now working on a book that 40 years ago, we were 2-9-1 and flying all over the country. And here I am still talking about it years later. And the friendships and the connections that I made are lifelong.
Take a quick look at our Q-Burger Subaru drive of the game. Time for this drive, which occurred early action. Zach Larrier running the show for 11 plays, 88 yards. Did it by ground, did it by air. Zach Larrier had himself a ball game. It ends with a Burke touchdown plunge. And that is our Q-Burger drive of the game.
Yeah, I think that's a great one, too. That it showed Air Force's ability in both the run and the pass and with the new players and what they're capable of doing from this point going forward.
Air Force 15 players with at least one rushing attempt in this game. That is Air Force football. That's what they do to you. Trying to wind out the clock right now. Your book, what are you calling it?
Wings to Soar. Wings to Soar was the motto of my class of 1984 over the course from 1980 to 1983. Was really a transition from the old Ben Martin era to Ken Hatfield and the triple option and joining a conference. And we started at 2-9-1, finished at 10-2, 13th in the country. And then the program has just, for 40 years, been on an upward trajectory.
Well, 1-0 for 2023. The last chapter written on this game is Troy Calhoun shakes hands with Bernard Clark. Teams greet each other. Obviously not the kind of game Robert Morris wanted, but sort of the kind we expected. It's all Air Force, 42-7. If you're the Academy, you have Sam Houston State with Utah State right around the corner. You always have to keep your eye on the prize, but you can't look too far ahead. Again, conference play is a little different. Utah State has had the Falcons' number in recent years, but you can't overlook a Sam Houston.
No, you can't overlook a Sam Houston. They're going down there. They're going to play in the Texans stadium there. I call it Reliant. I think they've changed the name of it since then. But it's a great opportunity from a recruiting standpoint in a football-rich area, that greater Houston area down there in southeast Texas. That's exactly right. And we lean heavy there to bring cadets to the academy.
My favorite part of any game involving a military team is this. Walk us through what's happening.
Well, they're going to play the third verse of the Air Force song. And I said at halftime when we were talking about Hunter Brown, a toast. This verse is known as a toast, and it's to all the fallen airmen over the course of the entire history of the Air Force, a salute to them.
Reason to cheer here at Falcon Stadium as the Falcons put it on Bobby Moe, Robert Morris, 42-7 in the season opener. As we await our interview with Kitty Wingy and Coach Calhoun, do need to mention, if you're watching from home, there is some construction taking place here at Falcon Stadium. If you make it out here, the east stands are far different than they were a year ago. That's because they're adding a bunch of luxury suites on the east side.
Yeah, they really are. And it's really going to make this a special place to come and see an event, not just for football, but also they play lacrosse here at times. You'll see graduation here, and it's going to expand our ability to host and bring in VIPs and whatnot. So I'm really excited at how it's going to look.
$90 million renovation project that should be ready to go by kickoff next season. Zach Larrier started the game for the Falcons, and he started off with a bang. He played the entire first half, played into the third. I was most impressed with him throwing the ball. We knew he could run. Again, Zach Larrier is a two-time state champ or conference champion in the 200-meter and the 400-meter, but he's not fast enough to run away from Katie Wingy. She caught him. Katie?
All right, thank you very much. Zach, your first real game reps at that quarterback position. How did it feel to execute at such a high level?
Felt good, man. Just a blessing to get out there. And, you know, the days are numbered on playing football, so I loved it.
That pass play in particular, you guys are a team that have known for running the way that you do. What happened in that play, 21-0, is what you went up?
Yeah, we just called a pass play, and it worked better than I think it ever could, but it was good, and we executed, and it was a good play.
What can you say about the defense and the performance they had in this game, holding them to just 7 points?
Yeah, those guys over there, man, they fly around. It's just one of the greatest things to watch is those guys on the other side, they fly around. It's beautiful, and they did it today just like they did it every game last year, and they're going to do it every game this year, so I love to see it.
Congrats on the win. Good luck the rest of the season.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Gotta love that, Zach Larrier. We called a pass play. I passed it, and it worked. It's the way it's supposed to work. We'll wrap things up from Falcon Stadium after we had push-ups galore. 42 points worth for Air Force.
3s, Cat. Why?
Because 3 is greater than 2.
Refreshing.
Better than a buzzer beater 3.
Angel, that my story?
Again, 3 is greater than 2.
So we invented the 3-pointer.
If here equals 2, how about here equals 3?
But people weren't feeling it.
It just doesn't add up.
So we searched for a player who could own the 3.
Larry 4.
Refreshing aiming.
Starry or the 3?
Air Force touchdown!
winners of the Commander in Chief's Trophy.
Bring it home.
Air Force football is brought to you by First Bank. And by Huberger Subaru. Here in Colorado Springs, the Air Force Falcons defeat Robert Morris Colonials 42-7. The future is in your hands. Brought to you by Ball Corp. And the future of Zach Larry are bright this season. He's a senior. He hasn't gotten any starts at quarterback until today, and look at what he did by ground and by air.
Yeah, and the big thing about that position over the years with the great ones is the leadership and the calmness, the ability to come to the line of scrimmage, make the read, get them in the right play, and not show any shake if the defense happens to make a big play on you. And I thought he did exactly that today, Vic. Off to a great start.
Well, we're happy that you were here to join us for the game. And I know, Ted, you want to say goodbye in your own way. That was a pleasure to do this game with you.
Yeah, absolutely, Vic. And I can't wait to see how we do next week in my old hometown of Houston, Texas, against Sam Houston State.
Can't take the boy out of Houston. The Falcons roll 42 of them against Bobby Moe. Thanks for watching Air Force Football on Altitude TV.